Have a similar this or that?
We might have, but we're gonna. I'm also gonna. I've got a. He's gonna. He'll do his question. I have a follow up question.
We've been off for 2 weeks. We don't have to fucking talk.
Fucking kill you.
I didn't know it was a restaurant.
Look, I'll tell you.
He
right
was like,
now.
I went in and I got 3 rub and tugs and I didn't even get full.
I didn't get crab rangoon.
Do you have a story? No, Javier's got a story.
I mean, I've been.
I don't really have a story.
I thought you said living
with a 90-year-old woman.
Yeah.
I'm not living with a. I said, yes, he should tell that story.
Oh,
I'm not living with a 90-year-old woman. I've been living. Oh, I'm living with a 90. Oh, yeah, I've got that story. Okay. Yeah, yeah.
See, look, I think it's been like a. The lonely loner seems to free his mind at night.
He's all alone through the day and night. Day and night. Shut up. We're starting, okay? It is time to go.
I'm about to jerk off.
Get in here. We got to start the show. We got to start the show.
I think it was a little too forward with the jerking off.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, hello, everyone, and welcome to the Funky Panther. Coming to you from Fort Worth, Texas, we have got the most handsome episode for you.
That's a fucking lily.
Here on episode number 130. We have got the man, Mr. Daddy Paul of NEXM Creative here in the building. You want to say hey?
Hey.
Damn. Just if you don't meld with that voice, wow. Goddamn, I don't know
beautiful.
What to tell you.
Just beautiful.
That's all you told me to say was hey.
I said some other things, but yeah. So sit back, relax, and we hope you'll enjoy. I'm Chad.
I'm Javier.
I'm Tim.
And the three of us are...
The Funky Panther!
I'm already reading the comments. Holy watch tan.
Yes, I took it off because it was dead. And like, look wow. at this.
Oh yeah, that's very apparent on the video.
That is impressive.
I will Jeez. Say this also. Like,
it's
I work
the hole in the middle.
You work inside.
It is. You're right. It's
why is there a hole in the middle?
You're right.
Do you have a hole in your watch?
Oh my God, I think that's like a bruise. Oh my God, that's
probably
weird.
From wearing the watch at work.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But also, like, I'm working outside and
what?
On the group chat, Javi, show them your forehead. My forehead has like a
Can
you see like how tan?
Why are you working outside? I thought y'all had an inside situation.
How wild is that?
Yeah, that's pretty.
You got that hat tan line.
Jesus, I got the construction worker.
That is some working Mexican shit, right?
Brother,
there.
We're gonna have We gotta get you some spray tan or something, man.
Dude, I'm fucking
even that shit out.
What the hell's going on, man?
Wow,
Jesus, that's what happens.
For those not watching, you're gonna have to watch this because you can get to see Javier's weird tan lines
and also the handsomeness. It's Paul over here.
Yeah, yeah, you gotta watch the video just to see this man. Just a huh.
Just
so
a,
let's man. Let's start off with you, Javier. What have you been up to?
Well, a lot of work. Obviously, we've been gone for a month, so since then, like, it's hailed, and I've been busy with work and constant, like, continuous days.
Yeah.
And man, that's pretty much it. I just, you know, I've been living with my girlfriend for about a month now. And,
what? Oh yeah, you haven't been in this house.
I haven't been in this house.
In the house where the studio is. Yeah. You haven't been here in a while.
No, it's been like about a month, and I'm back now because I got tired of it.
Is that why it's so ridiculous. Clean?
That's why it's so clean. And there's cobwebs in places, and you know, there's a KY that's not being used in the bathroom.
Right. Right.
No, you didn't bring that to you.
I didn't. No, you think. You know, you don't need that. Obviously, because you know that's like it's nice, you know, there. And you know, I can't, she's on the chat.
Go
I'm
on.
Kidding. I'm just kidding. No, it was a great time. We've had like a great month, and you know, we're just testing the waters and how, like, you know, the next step of our relationship evolves. And
so this is your first time living?
This is my first time. I've never lived with anyone other than my parents. So it's...
Not even in college?
I did have college roommates. Okay. And they were cool. I'm still friends with one, and he's a band director in like a rich part of the city, but it's weird. It was just completely different than what I've been used to, you know.
Okay. Any weird things that have happened? Or
yeah,
any, like...
yeah. You know, mainly the nagging, the nagging, and you know, just constant like, why didn't you? No, I'm just kidding. It's been a blast. We've had a great time. And,
good.
You're with the cats.
Yeah, I'm with the girls. The girls, you know, they're the black cat, Gigi. She's a, you know, a real bitch, and she's always like,
she liked me, all right.
She did, yeah. But Lola, the flat faced Persian, very so cute, nice. Adorable. Whenever we're asleep, she's always next, cuddled
you know,
up next to me.
Just
man.
The way you just said that, the flat faced Persian.
Yeah,
man. She someone needs, could take that wrong.
She need,
Yeah, it doesn't sound great the way you said that. I'm not.
That sounds kind of racist, to be honest with you.
That's a gorgeous puss. I'll tell you that much. That's a real cute puss. Wow.
Oh, my God.
Well, good for you.
But yeah, the month went great. So she's supposed to be moving in in September. So I'm very excited for that. So
you've been working so damn much. I'm sure that y'all kind of only had a little bit of time.
We have, and she gets that. I mean, this is really, I mean, it's really the worst time of year with hail. So, I mean, I'm just like constantly busy.
But maybe it's a good reason for her to ease in. You know what I mean? Like, you're only there a few hours a day or whatever,
dude,
plus sleep.
She puts up with
tired of you too quick.
Right, absolutely. Yeah, 100%.
Best case scenario, honestly.
And my family doesn't listen, thank God. But, you know, like my mom left my dad for that reason because he worked so much. And it was just, I don't want to do the same shit, and she understands, and she's been a real trooper. And man, I couldn't honestly.
Hang on, we're getting a phone call in from Javier's mother.
Javier, it's your mother.
Hey, mom. What? Goddamn, are you from Georgia now, mom?
I do listen to you.
All right, that was Javier's mom.
Thank you, mommy.
Oh, thanks for calling in.
Love you,
Mrs. Wow. Javier.
I'm sweating now.
See you later.
Yeah. So that was my thing.
To his mom.
Oh, right.
Oh, my God. Okay,
see you later. Just leaving us.
No, I was
like, I'm done here.
Yeah, he's leaving to go see my mom.
To her.
Oh,
thank after you. This.
Honestly, I was gonna say it was Javier's mom and then pull up the what's it called?
Can you at least take her out to dinner before?
Yeah, I just said I was
gonna
bring her
dinner.
Take her dinner.
Oh my God.
And we don't have to. That way, it's only just a few steps to the next step.
Right. They're not going to eat yet.
Oh my God.
I mean, somebody's going to eat.
Stop it. I love it. Fantastic.
It's been a while.
Yeah, all right, man. Tim. What about you?
Paul, damn it, Paul.
Well, I discovered that I live with a 90-year-old.
You have someone else living in your house?
No, Jesse.
Is that what's that term? Frogging?
Frogging?
Excuse the fuck out of me.
Isn't that what it is?
I don't know what you're talking
about. I'm
pretty
sure. Frogging?
Why'd you look at me for confirmation on that?
I mean, you're older looking, what so is... I figured out. Figured you would know more vocabulary.
No, so she's so we're sitting there, we got YouTube TV, and she just looks over at me out of nowhere and says, "Hey, can you change the station?"
Oh my God.
We don't have fucking stations, man.
Turn the dial, please.
The last person that I've heard say change the station was my grandmother.
Back in 18-diggity-2, we were looking at Roosevelt.
I can't say much because I call it a channel changer.
Okay.
The remote. I call it a channel changer.
People forget, though, right? Did you ever have a TV where it was like, you know, you had to turn the dial and all that stuff?
I think when I was a child.
Yeah. Right?
So.
I think all of us would have.
We're all the same age, right?
Yeah,
right about.
Either that or like the push buttons on the TV. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I remember where it was like 13 little buttons or 9 buttons and you had to... Yeah.
That shit was wild.
And the remote looked like a fucking brick.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's fucking massive.
And my brother caught it.
For no reason.
My brother
just no reason. It was
burned
just huge.
He burned the remote. We had the same remote for a long time. He was playing with a cigarette lighter and burned it.
Wow.
You know, scraping the, if you rolled the flint off of it,
mm-hmm.
and you could put it all down in something and light it, and it would, yeah, that's what he did.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool. Oh,
interesting.
Cool,
on
this
brick remote.
That's ooh, sorry. All right. Fire.
Arson.
Arson. He caught my grandma's backyard on fire, too.
Hey, shout out to arson.
No kidding, right?
I think my brother had a thing with fire.
Sounds like the fire department. Well, I hope it goes well with you and your 90-year-old lady. Yeah. Good luck with that.
The reason I said frogging.
Frogging. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, frogging is terrifying. Frogging is the act of someone living in your home without you knowing.
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
That's when you said, I realized I had a 90-year-old living in my home. I was like, fuck, frogging? Like, how scary is that? It's usually almost never violent.
But they're like living up in your attic or something?
Yeah. And they only come out and take little snacks to survive in the middle, either while you're sleeping or while you're at work.
There's been like whole movies about that.
There was a movie called I See You.
Yeah.
It was recent with Helen Hunt. Don't know what happened to her. I think the fire department got a hold of her after some arson because she looks really bad. It's very strange.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's really bad. I remember Twister, and then it was just like, fire.
I love Helen Hunt.
Yeah, it was good. As good as it gets.
Oh,
that was
my
a great
God.
Movie.
That was
Jack
great,
Nicholson.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. She was in that. She was great.
She was
great.
Naked in that, wasn't she? Or which one was she naked in?
I think you're right.
Yeah,
I think you're right. Yeah.
I can go for some.
I think it was one to two nipples.
Goddamn.
One to two.
Mm. One to two.
Somewhere between one and two nipples.
Yes. One to two.
Like in What Women Want, I wanted her. Like she was pretty fancy.
Oh, that she was great. She was.
All right, I'm about to find out. I'm looking at Helen Hunt and finding out what she was in. She was nude in Blind Spotting, the movie Ride, The Seasons.
Oh, so you said she's looking bad? Is this
Soul Surfer?
No, she in that movie. I don't know if they made her look bad, but there'd be no reason to make her look bad because there wasn't a fire involved anywhere. But it looked like she had some scarring on her face.
Damn,
gotcha.
It was really crazy. Like I saw
as
it,
good
like,
as
oh
you
my
gets.
Gosh,
she was
as good as
that,
it gets. Yeah, she was nude. But dude, I can see. I see you. Crazy movie, and it does involve frogging.
Okay,
you've got to see it.
All right, I'll watch it.
I was so surprised where it went. Because I was not excited. I was not excited because I was like, these past, I've seen two scary movies recently, and they were so good into the last 7 minutes.
Yeah.
And then I was hating it. I was like, this is a waste.
Isn't that the worst, though?
Yep. Smile.
Oh, really?
Horrible.
Never actually watched it.
The whole thing was so good into the last 7 minutes, and I was like, are you fucking kidding me?
That sucks because...
Why would you do that?
That's how like, I felt about M. Night Shyamalan's movie where it turns out the trees were killing everybody. Whatever the suicide movie was.
Oh, The Happening?
Yeah, yeah I thought that was great. And then it comes, and then it comes out, it's like, oh yeah, planet Earth is... And I was like, oh my God, you gotta...
They were fighting back.
I was like,
they're
what
like,
the
planet
fuck?
Earth.
Like, hey, bitch, turn your cars off.
Right. That's what they said.
Yeah, that's exactly what they said. Hey, Wynn, help us out! And people were jumping off bridges.
Oh, I swear, I thought he was talking to somebody. I was like, yeah.
Frogging. It's getting a little hot in here, Wind. Can you help us out? Come on with it.
All right, gentlemen. We all have to blow on Javier.
Not the first, not the last.
Oh,
right, boys?
Hey.
All right,
actually,
moving on.
Speaking of blowing, I've heard Javier has some burning desires with my name on it.
So you haven't been here on the show, but the conversation about your penis has been on the show multiple times.
At least twice, possibly three times.
Yeah, it's gotten some definite airtime here on the Funky Panther.
Dude, I mean, you know, the realest thing is being comfortable with your sexuality. And I, for one, am a man of many cultures and many traits.
Sexualities.
Sensualities and sexualities. So okay. I, for one, yeah, I mean, obviously, yes. If you had bottled your bathwater, obviously, I think I might drink it. I'm not sure, but I think maybe your essence would be in me and I'd like get the, you know, whenever you like eat an animal, you're like spirit of eagle because you eat an eagle.
Yeah.
I think that's you. I think if I take your essence, then
there'll always be a piece of me inside of you, Javi.
Yes. Oh my God. You're just like Jesus or whatever the priest told me in Catholic school.
Oh my gosh.
Uncle? Wait, what?
What? Different conversation for a different time.
Different time.
This got dark.
Speaking of priest, shout out to the really awkward apology from the Dalai Lama.
Bro, that was fucking crazy.
That like, was
that's
fucking
not in my news.
It's insane. Not? No, it was yesterday.
Did y'all hear about that? Did y'all hear that?
No.
No.
Bro. Dude, the Dalai Lama, like, so he was having some...
It was his
like a
meet
and greet?
It was his heir. It was his heir of like taking over the Dalai Lama ship. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I didn't know that, but it was a young child, probably 10 years old.
Yeah, yeah.
Probably 10.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe like 8 or 10, something like
8
that.
8 to 10, right? And so he comes up, gives him a hug, and then he's like, give me a kiss. So the little boy gives him a kiss, and then
he
starts,
sticks his tongue out. Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Hold
yeah.
And then he like kind of rubs his head for a second, and then he's like, suck on my tongue.
No, he fucking
swear.
Did.
All
right,
dude,
coming in
from, I thought it was
from
fake,
CNN,
too.
The Dalai Lama has apologized after a video emerged showing the spiritual leader kissing a child on the lips and then asking him to suck my tongue.
Holy
at an event
shit.
In northern
dude,
India.
It was... I was very disturbed when I watched it.
Obviously.
When I watched it, like because when I heard it, I was like, "Is this a joke?" Because I thought it was like some AI thing. Because you know that's all over the place, right?
Yeah.
And then it was everywhere. And I watched the video only once. Never watched it again because it was so uncomfortable.
Right?
Like to see him as this spiritual leader telling this, and the little boy did not want to do it, and you could tell.
Yeah.
You could tell the little boy was so uncomfortable and upset and didn't know. I mean, it's the Dalai Lama.
Yeah.
Like, what do you do? Oh, it was so horrible.
It's kind of like, you know,
holy
one of those
shit.
It's one of those positions of power thing that's kind of like trippy. And I'll tell you, do you know why I'm like very disappointed in that? Because like one of my favorite movies is 7 Years in Tibet.
Yeah.
And that's about him.
Brad Pitt.
Yeah. That's about him. And he's, you know.
Brad Pitt's a Dalai Lama?
Yep. Yep, he sure is.
It's kind of like when Tom Cruise was the Last Samurai, right?
Oh, God damn it.
Oh, yeah.
A little whitewashing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a little. And then Matt Damon was also a samurai, right?
Matt Damon.
Was he?
What was he in where he was?
Well, he played an angel in Dogma.
Well,
that
was
fantastic.
He was a rocker in like Euro Trip. Scotty doesn't know.
Oh, yeah.
The Fiona and me put him up in on Sunday. That was my shit.
It's actually been claimed as one of the best non-real songs ever created.
It is. Well, because everyone knows it. Everyone knows the lyrics.
Everyone knows it.
Yeah, bizarre.
Yeah, anyways. Very creepy, though. It's like, you know.
I was not ready to see that because it, like, what I wonder what that will do to that culture. And, like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, what will that do to, because, I mean, but you also have to understand that he's just a man.
Yeah.
So they can have horrible things go on in their brains and actions. They're not any greater or lower than anybody else.
Right.
And people forget that.
Yeah.
And then they're like, oh, no. And then you see something horrible. I just wonder what it does to that belief in the people that follow him and that culture. It's like, oh, my God. Oh, it freaked me out, man.
It's crazy.
It's crazy.
Yeah. All right, let's go on the upside of things.
Yeah. Well,
sorry about that. That was just current news.
Hey, I mean, I'm glad you brought it up because I honestly, like, you know, we were talking about like a format switch. Like, we were going to try to change things up. And, you know, I thought he would have it.
Yeah.
But thankfully, you know.
No, well, I did not.
That's crazy,
that.
Though. That shit is. And I thought, too, I was like, that shit's AI.
So his office says the spiritual leader does regret the incident.
Yeah.
Well, I fucking hope so.
So, I mean, I guess that's the one good thing that's come out of that. He has regret.
But again, is it the first? It's not the first. It cannot be the first time. No.
That's what also scares me, because then my brain goes down the rabbit hole of like, what all has he done to these young kids?
Well,
which scares the heck out of me.
The way you explain it makes it sound like it was very comfortable for him. Like it would just seem like a funny thing.
He was in front of people.
And then, like, press conference.
This was a huge event.
So the tweet says, a video clip has been circulating that shows a recent meeting when a young boy asked His Holiness, Dalai Lama, if he could give him a hug. His Holiness wishes to apologize to the family and the boy, as well as his many friends across the world, for the hurt his words may have caused. His Holiness often teases people he meets in an innocent and playful way, even in public and before cameras. He regrets the incident.
How about you come here and suck this toe?
What kind of teasing is that?
What the fuck kind of teasing?
I ain't teasing nobody. I ain't going up to a little child. Hey there, suck my tongue. Like, what the fuck, man? No,
that is a weird fucking
I don't think
tease.
I've ever said that anytime.
Suck I don't care tongue. What culture you're in or where ever. You live in the world. Suck my tongue is not a tease.
There's nothing spiritual about that, I promise.
As the great Red Hot Chili Pepper said, suck my kiss.
Okay.
So.
Right.
Maybe that's what he meant.
Now, I have told the Puerto Rican that owed me money. I said, suck my dick from the back. But, you know, that was
gathered from this whole situation, though, is that we're canceling the Dalai Lama? Is that a thing?
To be seen. I mean, here at the Funky Panther, we don't have a stance.
Yeah, we don't.
We think it's strange and weird. But, disturbing. Likely going to get, completely canceled.
On the group chat, yeah, totally. Corks and Cowtown regret he got caught. That's
That's what it is.
Obviously.
Kate, are you doing okay? Ha, ha.
Okay.
Did something happen?
She's on the chat. Kate's on the chat.
She said
your voice is sexy. Yeah.
Heart eyes.
Okay, we get it. All right.
Oh, that voice is melting.
It's melting.
You got to smile with your voice.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. And
he's doing a wonderful job.
All right, real quick before we get into news, just something that me and the guys have talked about. Obviously, we haven't had an episode for a couple of weeks. Shout out to Tim for dropping the kind of best of like filler episode.
Yeah, it's just a mix of things.
Yeah,
I hope somebody enjoyed it.
I listened to it, and it kind of reminded me, like, I liked listening to the Minicon piece and listening to Lance whenever I was in Egypt and things like that. It was kind of cool to catch back up on old things that I forgot about. And so we might do that, you know, in lieu of us missing a week or so in the future. Let us know what you think about that. Also, the three of us had a meeting last week trying to figure out what we want to do with the Funky Panther moving forward.
And we decided that this is the last episode. Paul's our last guest, and we're done. Thank you, everybody. Have a good night.
Bye, y'all.
Later.
I'm just kidding.
So, you know, I mean, we're talking about format, things that we want to do. We've got a lot of ideas in the hopper, a lot of things that we want to do. Obviously, we're all very busy, and we want to make sure we give the best possible content to you. But, you know, let us know what you want to hear from us. Let us know on social media at The Funky Panther. You can also email us at thefunkypanther@gmail.com or call us, 817-677-0408. We also plan on putting out there on social media asking you what you want to hear from us, what you want to see from us in the future, because we really are going to lean in on you and what you want from us, so we make sure we give you the best possible content. So make sure you let us know, because you're the reason we do this in the first place.
You know what I noticed? That
Paul still has a shirt on?
We had several
big mistake there.
So far.
Our videos that we tell some sort of story
yeah.
tend to do really well on our social media.
Yeah.
And I think we should just get back into back to where it all began.
Bullshit and storytelling.
Talking about the dick flowers, you know?
And like, I agree. Not pandering to other people and, like, you know, recording 20 times a day or something.
Speaking
like
of dick flowers, I don't know what a dick flower is, okay, but it reminded me of an experience.
All right.
Not personal. Well, it was personal, but not that personal. Did you... Not sure if you've ever heard of this, and hopefully it's not too far-fetched for the audience.
No, I've definitely heard of it.
Okay.
Already know.
Yeah, so I went to an adult store several years ago. And
yesterday. He means yesterday. Go on.
No, I wish. It's been a while. I miss it.
They knew my name there.
They did. They were like, well, they didn't know my real name. They they would call me.
They know the name.
Yeah, and they would call me Zeus.
Oh,
the industry name.
That's my porn name. Yeah. Zeus Ravenswood.
Oh my
shit.
Oh yeah.
That's gorgeous.
That's the first dog in the first street you live on. I'm just saying, the first dog's name in the first street you live on.
Really?
What's that? Yeah, what is that? What's yours?
It was Ben and Glenwick. So that's
okay. That's not bad.
That is awful. Ben Glenwick.
Okay.
That is a fucking
sounds like
awful
a serial killer.
Point. Yeah.
All right, Javi.
Mine's Blackie St. Louis.
What? I can't follow up with that one.
Nope.
Well,
there we go.
And it's canceled.
Nice try, Paul. Nice try.
Great.
Benji Highridge.
All right. That's
Benji
a good one.
Highridge.
That sounds like a. I'm not going to say it because I don't want to get canceled. It sounds like a person, like if I was back in like the 1800s and I was native.
Yeah.
And like the white man gave me the name Benji. And I was actually High Ridge, Running Wolf, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah, you couldn't get canceled for that at all.
No.
Yeah, ours suck.
Yeah.
Not like fucking Zeus.
Oh,
Ravens
anyways,
would.
Anyways, yeah, so I was in an adult store and there was a sign in the back in this hallway and it said, you know, this way for more or whatever. And I was like, oh, cool. Right? And I was like,
wait,
why not go look?
Wait,
there's more.
I want more.
Let's keep moving. Let's keep traveling through the more store, right? So I walked back this hallway. It opens up into this other shop.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Right? And
it's like a sex store speakeasy?
I like where this is going.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe it was like on the back side of the store. There was a front side of that store.
Yeah.
And it was kind of like, you know, like that. It was crazy.
Nice.
And it was the homosexual side.
Oh, okay.
Which I was like, oh, this is kind of interesting. Like, it was, I don't give a shit, but it was so, like, it was crazy over there. But I saw something I'd never seen before.
Okay.
And I didn't know it was a thing.
What is the thing?
Urethral spreaders.
I was about to say that.
Yeah, it's called sounding.
Wait, hold
my
on.
My penis.
Yeah. Yes.
Wait, hold on. What?
It is horribly crazy.
No, they have
actually gauged sizes.
Oh,
they get bigger and bigger and bigger.
Yeah, they recommend starting off small first.
Oh, is that the recommendation?
And then working your way up.
Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I figured I'd start giant and then work my way down.
You know, there's a urethral vibrator.
Yes, there is. Yeah. There's a urethral spreader, so it goes in and you vise it open.
Okay. That's great.
You've had it. I've got an STD test before.
Yeah. Oh, dude. Yeah. Ha. Fuck everyone who hasn't gotten one back when I got one.
You get the fucking Q-tip.
Yeah.
No, Q-tip inside the tip, and then you...
And they spin it.
Yeah.
Okay, so now...
Fuck you.
Now it's urination. Now it's through pee.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Easy. Right?
Yeah.
Back in the fucking day,
It was gigantic.
It was huge, and the tip of it was the same size, probably, as the ear.
About the size of your fist, I believe.
I'm rubbing my dick right now.
It sure as hell felt like. Dude, I was sore for at least 2 weeks from it. Because
I didn't want to have sex after that.
Dude,
I think that's a point.
I think it is, too.
This is a way for them
that
to go.
Wasn't even,
you know what? You don't want to do this anymore after this.
You actually just spit on a piece of paper, and they can tell you if you've got, you know, chlamydia, but they just wanted to jab you with the Q-tip and the P-tip.
It was literally.
Can I tell you what it felt like? It honestly felt like whenever they put it in, they like snapped their finger twice, and like it just went.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
It sounds awful.
Can I tell you what it felt like? I thought it felt like razor blades.
It did feel
like the Q-tip had blades in it,
and then it felt like razor blades for at least a week after that.
Every time
I peed.
Every time
you
peed.
God damn, dude. Wait, what?
What?
Yeah, no, it totally like fucking like I'm grabbing myself because of
we noticed.
Like yeah. I forgot. Like,
you don't have to explain why you're grabbing yourself.
We are on video.
Let me ask you though. Okay, so Paul says he's been to a porn store. Y'all been to porn stores?
Yeah,
like the actual like the ones that got the like the movies and stuff. That's like not the sex stores. Like
oh, yeah, you know you've been to the porn store with you know they got the
like you mean like the XX movies? Yeah, ones? Like, I'm like where about they have XX, like a theater.
The yeah. XX movie ones.
Nah, well, I go to the porn stores that have like toys and stuff, yeah, and I guess yeah. they have those. Like on like when you go on the country road ones, they have both in one.
Let
place.
Me ask you: have you ever driven out towards Brock and all that?
Yeah.
And
the, yeah,
dude, that there's that one on the side of the road over there by Temptations that kind of freaks me out.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Like. There's always a bunch of cars there.
Yeah.
There's always a bunch of cars.
You know yeah. what goes on there, right?
Glory I'm sure baby. A lot of dick sucking probably goes on there.
Why? Well,
I imagine okay. that.
Well, I mean, that sounds like a fantasy of yours, but what I was going
to say. He's like, I really been wanting to go check it out.
No, there's a whole bunch of cars outside. Got to be dick sucking. Yep. Got to be dick sucking.
It's the lodge. It's out in the middle of nowhere.
Fuck. Right. Look at Walmart. It's packed. Dick sucking. Look at Chick-fil-A. Look at all the people in line. Dick sucking.
Just waiting in line. Hey, can I give you a 1 to 5 on the dick sucking? No, what do you want from the menu?
Can't wait for the Polynesian sauce.
But it's
hernia just came out.
That's it's creepy over there. Like it just like that's a store that I don't want to go into.
I'll be honest,
seem
with you,
that inviting.
The majority of those stores are kind of creepy and not very yeah. inviting. Like you've got like remember when we used to go out to like Windstar.
Yeah,
and there's like
yeah.
a dozen on Highway 35 up to Windstar.
Yeah, there really is.
Well, there's a ton.
Like, it's like both sides yeah, of the highway
it's
for
non-stop.
Like 10
it's
miles.
Like if I want to go to the casino,
like 60 miles.
I also want to get a ton of fucking porn on the way. You know what I mean? But like, we took my brother for his 18th birthday up to Windstar.
Oh, and so
we
I thought actually, you were talking about to the porn store.
We did.
Oh, okay.
So we're like, you're 18. We're going to take you to the casino because now you can gamble. We're also going to take you to the porn store because you're 18. You can do it.
Hell yeah.
But also, I don't think I had been, and so it was more of a reason for me to go, I think. So we go in, and we're like, ha, ha, look at this, ha, ha, look at that. You know what I mean? And
hiding
it
your
was very
erection
insightful.
In the,
it was
in
very
the belt
insightful.
Of your pants?
Like,
yeah.
Like so, where it was like, oh, she's cute.
Did you learn something about yourself?
But she also is not a she. And I was like, well, never mind. I need to leave this store. This is making me feel weird.
Someone's confused. So someone Whoopsie. Said, hold on, sorry, I'm going to read the chat. Someone said, women have to get viced open once a year. And yes, and you know, kudos to all women. You guys
Absolutely.
Endure more pain than we could ever imagine. But you guys,
however,
not to discredit anything that you have to go through, you welcome things into that hidey hole, and we do not. There are things that never go the reverse direction in our little hidey hole.
Unless you're into the sound.
Right, that is the well, yeah. that is the only time.
Okay, we need to move on. I need to get this image out
all
of my
right,
head.
All right, all right,
of the
all right.
Pee hole.
Oh, you want to see an image?
No,
of
no,
it.
No, no, no. I need to get it out of my head. Moving on to news. Yeah, I think we're ready for the news.
I'm
yeah,
show
I
you here.
No,
a
you won't.
I will. I want everyone's going to see his reaction. On, I'm not going to show it, of course, but I sure as hell will show him. I want to see his reaction.
They made me watch Two Girls, One Cup.
And now, it's time for news with Tim! Take it away, Tim!
I'm glad. I'm very glad.
A month was not long enough.
Yeah. Higher and higher. Yeah, you want a sexy voice.
Boy.
That's fucking sexy
Talk
voice,
about
motherfucker.
Shrill.
I see it down there.
All right.
It did something.
So did you hear about this April Fool's joke that somebody decided to do with the presidential election that's coming up? Did y'all hear about that?
No.
So somebody filed Greg Abbott's petition to run for president.
Oh my God.
And it freaked out everybody.
Seriously?
Yeah, like they actually submitted it. His campaign says it's false. Only time will tell. He's saying it's false. I don't believe it. I think that was real. I think he was putting some feelers out.
He said, I'm gonna put my leg in the race.
And then I'm going to put my other leg in the race.
I'm going to jump in both feet forward.
Everybody,
you know what I mean?
Stand up. Stand up and rise for the pledge. Not you, Governor, because you cannot.
Okay. You make it that
forward,
obvious. It's not funny.
Forward.
Yeah, so somebody decided that they thought it would be a good joke to go ahead and petition for his spot in the presidential election. And he's coming out and saying, no, okay. I truly believe. No,
yeah,
you got to look.
Yeah.
Just look.
I truly
believe that Abbott was just putting out feelers, really.
You stupid motherfucker. You stupid motherfucker.
The more you know. You know what?
Hey.
Chad, knowing is half the battle.
Don't kink shame.
Yeah, man.
Seriously.
Don't kink shame.
Don't kink shame.
This is a podcast of non-kink shaming podcasts.
What?
Right? Did I say that right?
I don't,
we don't
no
kink, shame.
Kink shaming
No
here.
Kink shaming here.
Chad looks like right? He wants to go home.
No kidding.
So, no kink shaming, okay? But it's
but
not
it's
for
not
everybody.
For you. It's not for you.
Some things make you want to not live anymore.
Some things are
and that was one of those things.
Unpenetrated.
Or unseen, motherfucker. Like, why did you do this to me?
Because the internet.
Because of the internet.
Yeah, we had a whole segment that died. But, you know, we're going to bring it back. So Governor Abbott saying that he didn't file it. I feel like after they got the backlash of so much hatred, he was like, oh, no, we didn't.
There's no
we,
way.
No, we didn't do it, yeah.
However, if everyone's like, yeah, fuck yeah, about time.
Well, yes, like, well, yeah.
I put this in myself.
Yeah, so now I've got a question for you. And I want to know, is this something that we should get for the Funky Panther? So the MTV gong from the 1980s is up for action or auction. What?
Action auction.
Say it again.
I can't speak. The MTV gong from the 1980s is up for auction.
Ooh, how much?
Do you remember? It's expecting to fetch $10,000 to $15,000.
Oh, that's actually not that bad.
That actually sounds like something that should be in Paul's studio.
Yeah,
because if you haven't been to Paul's studio, which we'll get into, he's got a plethora of neat things all over the walls.
It's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd love to spend 10 to 15 grand on a gong. On
that says MTV Music Television.
Okay. Like you haven't spent stupid money before.
Nope. Oh, ask. I don't do that.
I believe you.
I really do not.
We need to start a GoFundMe for the gong for Paul's studio.
That might actually, we might need to do that. So if y'all want to
really
contribute.
And we could all like come and like we could like sit around it.
Pause.
Sorry, we could all come. Pause around it. Pause again. Together. Pause. Might as well just reverse this shit right back. Pause, pause, pause.
I remember as a little kid, I didn't have cable TV at home, so I'd go to my grandma's house, and she didn't know what I was watching, and so I'd watch MTV a lot.
Is that one of the stations you would watch?
Yeah, it was one of the stations that I would turn to. She would ask me, turn that station to something else.
Click on over to another station.
Yeah, I remember the MTV gong. Do y'all remember the gong?
I don't.
I don't either.
I don't. I'm acting like I do.
I was actually I was a VH1 whore, not an MTV person.
Okay. Pop-up video?
Yes.
We didn't have VH1 at my grandma's, so we weren't that fancy. I know.
So whenever you were super...
Oh, my God.
Wow. So whenever you were super young, your grandmother had to have been like 110 already, right? Because you were like... How old was she?
Yeah, so my dad currently is 83. So whenever I was really young, my grandma was in her 70s.
Oh, yes, so she was
not
older.
So far off. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Wow. Also, yeah. They can get shot.
That wouldn't surprise me, but no, she used to tell me stories about.
It would surprise me because the math doesn't work.
She
out.
Lost her. She lost her first tooth in a covered wagon.
I thought you were going to say virginity. This like, gonna get real weird.
Yes.
She
lost her virginity in a covered wagon.
Oh my God.
All right, on her way to a rally. It was so weird.
Oh my God!
I didn't say what kind of rally. Relax.
It was for the love of all people.
Yes.
All right. So, Chad, is this something that you would do? Let me ask you. Man visits all 12 Disney parks around the world in 12 days.
That sounds like something Natasha would do, like Anthony's wife.
I don't Disney think that parks? You. I don't. Yeah. So all 12. So there's 12
in the world.
In the world, and he did it in 12 days.
No.
You wouldn't do that. Have you been to Disney? You've been to Disney, right?
Well, I used to live in California, so I'm from California. So Disneyland was my thing. I've never been to World, and I heard that's pretty amazing.
Disneyland is in the ghetto.
It's Orange County, right? Yeah. My cousins lived down
outside
the street
of
from
outside of
Anaheim. Yeah. I mean, but. That's very nostalgic for me.
Yeah.
I liked it a lot.
I'm not a theme park person.
Right, you're not a theme park person, but I just saw like, okay, 12 parks in 12 days.
You mean like for the challenge?
And around the world.
Okay, listen, first off.
You're up for a good challenge, no.
I like the idea of traveling 12 places in 12 days. I love that fucking idea. However, you know how much money it would cost to not only travel, which is fine, I get that, but to travel to a theme park? As expensive as Disney World and Disneyland every single day for 12 days.
So I'm gonna.
That is a $25,000.
Possible.
I don't. That's a $30,000.
I don't think
trip.
that's even possible.
I don't know.
It is. Because well, I mean, think about it. How long does it take you to get to all these places? You've got your layovers. You got to get from the airport to the park. Do you have to just like walk in the front door, then walk right back out? Because
no,
you
no,
can't
no.
enjoy yourself.
So here's the other thing. Here's the other kicker to it. So he not only did that, but he also took a spin on all 216 operating rides, is what they're claiming.
That's bullshit.
Now that doesn't sound right at
all. That's not real.
Unless Nathan Firesheets. I mean, what? Probably what? A fake name.
That's a good pimp.
That's like a good. That sounds like a good fireman. kind of like a fire chief Les McBurney.
Oh. You've seen McBurney?
That meme? Les McBurney.
Yeah.
So he started this project, the Disney Global Ride Challenge, on March 8th at Disneyland Paris, and completed his journey at Florida's Magic Kingdom on Sunday. The days in between saw Firesheet visit Walt Disney Studios, Shanghai, Disneyland, Hong Kong, Disneyland, Tokyo Disneyland, Tokyo DisneySea, Disneyland, Disney California Adventure, Epcot, Animal Kingdom, and Hollywood Studios.
Here's the deal. Is two things had to happen. Well, this person had money. Well, two things had to happen. Hold on.
Sponsored? Okay, go ahead.
One,
yeah.
It had to be sponsored.
It had to have been.
Right, where they're allowing him to like come right in
I'm sure.
And go straight to these rides, or he's paying out the fucking ass.
He did not disclose how much money he spent.
There's like a fast pass.
He's having to buy the fast passes. But we also have like a lot of these places. So Disney World has four theme parks there?
And where?
And at Disney World. That's four, yeah. that's four theme parks there. So it's not like he's having to go to like.
I think somebody said four or five in Orlando.
Yeah, there's like Hollywood Studios, Animal Kingdom, Epcot.
Magical Kingdom.
I mean, I read them
and,
off.
Yeah, did you? I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, we know.
Epcot, Animal Kingdom, and Hollywood Studios.
I only had a slice of food.
Javi's too drunk nail over there.
Oh, yeah?
Actually, no, I used this to pick my ear.
It's pretty disgusting.
That is so...
Yeah.
I'm okay. Sorry.
So you think it's a Coke nail.
Who lives with you.
But instead, it's an earwax nail because he's fucking disgusting.
She tells me that. She's like, God damn it.
He's a goblin. Javi's a goblin person.
A goon and a goblin. I think that's bullshit.
I mean, I only can go by what...
How about flights? Was he on a private jet to all of them?
He had to have been.
But I mean, how do you align the flights?
I mean, I don't know. You plan your routes.
Listen,
and
I fly to Prague on Thursday.
Oh, look at me! I travel around the world.
My first flight is 9 hours. Yeah. You could just sleep overnight. Like it's not that far fetched to say you just sleep overnight on the plane and then immediately get to the park. I mean, like that could happen.
Just hits the ground running. Gets the first taxi he sees, take me straight to this park.
Right.
Hits it up, goes, does
he
the
rides.
He
has to be a billionaire because he would have to get picked up, helicoptered in. Traffic.
You're not
you've
wrong.
You've got all that stuff. There's no possible
But I don't think
way.
It has to be a private jet. I think he could do a regular plane, but it would
I don't
still
think
be
so.
Fucking expensive.
You would have to plan it out with the airlines.
I think there had to have been so much planning with it. I mean, this honestly sounds like a Chad would have done this. And not saying that's a bad thing. Chad's just really good at planning and dictating like his trip, right?
So he said dick.
You try.
He said Chad was good with dick. Everyone heard it. He said it.
Yeah, Chad's good with dick.
I don't think that's a good thing.
wait a second. With my own.
You're getting red, buddy.
Oh no.
All right.
Oh, I made a mistake.
But I think that you could plan it out. I think you could plan it out. Shut and up, if buddy. you laid it all out, you'd be fine. All right. So moving on.
Oh, real quick, I did get a text from my official Disney person, Natasha. There is a trip to take you to all of them, just not a race. Like, not a race to, like, you know.
You can't
like
be a certain race?
No. No, oh hey, whoa, hold
goodness.
On.
Wow.
What?
This is an old Disney. I'm talking, like, new Disney. Like, there's no, like, there's a thing that'll take you to all the parks. Like, there's a thing that you can sign up for to take you to all...
Yeah.
But not
a
like
plane.
A
plane.
Exactly. And then you get a car, and it takes you there.
All right, moving on.
I'm
all right.
Drunk.
So, y'all are familiar with Last of Us, Chad?
Yeah.
Not so much. Have you watched it?
Yeah, I watched it all.
I've only watched the first four episodes.
Okay, but you kind of understand a little bit about what's going on, right?
I played the video games.
Fungus, right?
Yeah.
All right, so a mycologist becomes the first person in the world to contract the plant fungal disease.
Who
we
does?
This mycologist. We okay. didn't think that was possible to get fungus from a plant, right? Mm-hmm. But he's the first one to get it, so it is it's happening.
It can actually happen, yeah.
It can happen. They already have that fungus that controls ants, and that's kind of what it's basically loosely based off of on Last of Us. So now we're just waiting for that fungus to cross the insect to human barrier, and then we're all fucked.
Yeah.
All right.
That's great news, Tim. Thank you for that.
So just to finish it off, though.
Finish me off, Daddy.
Now, they're saying that people that are 50 years or younger
yeah.
have the possibility, A, to live to 140.
Yeah.
And B, they're saying immortality is going to be achieved by 2030.
Yes, I did see that, and fuck, I'm going to be immortal.
Bro, we had a whole episode about this.
Exactly. So they're saying that by 2030, we're going to be able to grow anything.
Yeah.
And they're saying that you could attend your own funeral in a new body.
They also said that the way the technology...
So forced reincarnation.
Yes.
They also said the way the technology is working, our age group, like mid-30s or whatever, could be the last age group of all time to be able to live forever. So everyone older than us, you're fucked. But anyone our age group and younger
yeah.
has the will possibly have the ability to live forever.
I don't want to, man.
I do. You know what's funny?
Fuck,
I've had this conversation. People are like, but all your loved ones will die. I'm like, I'll have new loved ones. No, I'll get, I mean, it's going to be sad.
So here's where I'm going to get a conspiracy on this. And I told Chad earlier, I've got a conspiracy about this.
If vampires can do it, first off, I mean, we can do it.
I feel like this technology has been around for a long time.
Yeah.
I believe it's been around for a long time. And I think that the state that, well, number one, the United States.
Yeah.
The United States. We're not going to have Social Security. And so this is just a way to prolong people's lives to keep them working because they won't be able to pay out in Social Security.
Oh, don't get me on this.
And then you got France who is writing about all their Social Security and social like services and stuff.
Yeah.
So it's not just a United States thing. The global network or global one world order or whatever, they're doing this, and I think it's just to keep us alive longer.
Paul, did you ever watch the movie that one with In Time with Justin Timberlake?
Of course I did.
Do you?
That was such a crazy cool concept,
right?
But I think that's how it'll be.
I think so. You're absolutely right.
Yeah, no, because what's interesting, what you just said, it brings me into another not conspiracy but fact.
Okay, let's go into it.
Is that our Social Security numbers is just a stock number.
Yeah, that's just
what it is.
It's our serial number.
It is our serial number.
Right.
That because what happens to all the money we've ever paid into everything once we die? Our loved ones usually don't get to claim that.
Right.
It gets taken somehow.
Estate tax, you know,
something,
stuff like that.
Right. So it just gets absorbed.
Yeah.
So they're hoping that our serial number, we get gone. So, which leads, if that happens with the immortality, then twiddly twat.
I feel like I'm
then in time. I can see that absolutely happening. Yeah.
But I see that also as like a population.
Fuck,
control.
I was like fucking moving that.
You were.
Shit.
You were
getting it.
But like
Saturday Night Fever, just in my arms.
I think the thing is like you're 25. That's the oldest you'll age. You're 25 years old, and you got to work until you're every day to replenish that time. But I think it's the same thing now. It's going to be kind of – it's like a system where the rich can control like, hey, here's your immortality. But we're going to still charge you for everything, your rent, your fucking life insurance. Yeah. So for
those of you who have not seen In Time, it's essentially like a bank. Like you
have
live as long as you can pay
your time,
your personal rent, essentially,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Like you're paying not for a place of rent. You're paying for your own time. And so what Javier's saying, right, is like you would have to pay your own time to continue your life longer, right?
Yeah.
But you would have to work as hard as you possibly can, unless you were the select few that were super, super rich, and then you don't live in the lower class slums.
Ooh,
of
and
the people.
Grids. Like they had like grids you had to go to.
Yeah, you had and you had to pass through.
Yeah.
You had to pass through all these different things of class levels. Dude, that movie was so
it's ahead of its
beyond
time.
Beyond its time.
Yeah,
man.
It's like a million years
dude,
in your
and
hand.
Justin Timberlake was so good in it.
He was.
He's a good actor, man.
He is, man.
I really liked him.
Yeah, he did a really good job with
good.
That. God damn, that was a really good movie.
I need to go watch that again.
I got to rewatch it. It was good. It was so good.
It was really good
because it made you feel whenever he was, when that guy gave him all that time.
Yeah.
And then he tried to give his mom the time that she had given him.
That was sad.
Bro,
dude.
Like final millisecond where he could have done it. It ended up like she died. Holy fuck, he did a good job on that.
Hey,
it was a good fucking movie.
Let me ask you this, though. Do you think that you would just get tired eventually, though?
No.
Like, you wouldn't get tired of living?
Fuck no.
No.
I'm already tired of paying taxes.
Well, see, I think after, if you're in a certain bracket, I think, absolutely you get tired of it. It's kind of, I mean, it's just that was just an embellishment of what we are today.
True.
Right? I mean, if you think about it, you know, you've got the people that have all the money that can just coast. Mm-hmm. And then you've got the employees from the movie that are busting their ass their entire life and their entire life only just to feed that little bit of time until they die.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's all it is. Mm-hmm. So that is just a very big exaggeration of how it is today. It's like if you only get to a certain point and never try to push yourself past that point, then you're literally working for your time until you die.
I will say one more thing before we move on. The final point to the movie. You saw the cop, Cillian Murphy, like he's like, yeah, he's working, right? And they're like, that's, hey,
it was Cillian Murphy, yeah, wasn't it? I was about to say that.
Yeah, they're like, hey, your per diem. You got to get your per diem, like his hours for his fucking time. He's like, oh, no way. I got to wait. Wait. No, there's something on the case. He fucking died because he was working and he should have fucking upped his time. Yep. When he
went to his little time clock thing.
So didn't it tells you that you shouldn't spend all your time working. But you got to do just enough to get by.
I do want
to
say this,
though,
real quick.
That's what I got from it.
I just want to say this. Like, I've been working a lot. I'm done, man. I'm after this storm's over, after this hail shit is gone, and I'm done.
You're ready to take time for yourself?
I'm ready to fucking take time. I'm ready to just, like, quit and, like, find something better because obviously.
Does your lady know that?
Well,
she's going to be the
breadwinner. She does now.
She's encouraging
that.
No,
I can get a cheat now. She'd rather see me somewhere better.
And her name is?
Yeah. Tammy.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Tammy, just letting you know, you are going to have a stay-at-home boyfriend.
I'm going to take care of the cats. Don't you worry, baby. I love you.
Oh, right. We'll take care of those cats.
Bro,
I'll take care of
cats don't need taken care of. That's why they're cats.
Listen.
You're doing nothing.
If there's something I've learned in the couple of months that I have not had a fucking job is like there are so many goddamn opportunities out there that can make you happier.
Yeah.
And also, I feel like the way there's been so many things that I've been able to do over the past couple of months without a fucking job. Like I've been able to reconnect with people I haven't seen in years. Like literally I'm having lunch with people that I haven't seen in years.
You just told a story about a man who like murdered kids and stuff or something. Right.
Right? Yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
no.
Child murderer.
No. So, I mean, like I'm seeing all these people that I'm friends with and reconnecting and like building these networks again and seeing what they're up to. But not only the relationships, but like you get to see like there's so many fucking opportunities. There's so many things to do.
Squirt.
Like I had a great time hanging out with Paul a couple of weeks ago, talking about different opportunities, thinking about different ideas and concepts. Like there's so much shit.
Yeah, that was really cool.
It was fun. And I wouldn't have had that opportunity to have that kind of time if I didn't have this time.
Did he talk to you about the one conversation that I talked to you about that I wanted to do?
Did it happen to do with taking your pants off?
We're going to talk about that after the podcast.
Dude, and hold on. Tell me that food wasn't fire.
Oh, my God. So he was talking about, like, he kept talking about this Thai food, which isn't just Thai food. It's like a...
It's Thai and Laos.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
So it's a Thai and Laos cuisine restaurant.
And holy shit, we ordered it, and he had it delivered, and that pad Thai was the best fucking pad Thai I've ever had in my entire life.
Asian Nights?
It sounds
Asian
like
Asian Nights in Haltom City.
Okay, so wait a second.
It sounds like a happy ending spot.
I thought that's what that was.
No. I mean,
you know what? I'm going to say right now, I think it is a happy endings place because I was sure as fuck happy after
I was happy as shit. I was so
dude,
happy.
We got the... Talk about the crab rangoons.
It was like real crab with a little bit of cream cheese or whatever. It was like real fucking crab. And it wasn't like too much of the...
I've driven past that place this whole time and I thought it was a rub and tug place.
Oh my goodness.
I didn't know it was a restaurant.
Look, I'll tell you right now.
He was like, I went in and I got three rub and tugs and I didn't even get full.
I didn't get crab rangoon. I will say one thing.
This place is fire and we're all going to go.
Yeah.
And we're going to order everything on the menu because it's, dude, their sticky rice is so fire. They have a jerky, which is like, it's called heaven beef or heaven jerky. That's incredible. Dude, the pad Thai is amazing.
So good.
The crispy pork.
I'm getting.
Bro, I'm fucking starving right now.
Crispy pork is my favorite.
Oh my
dude,
God.
Dude, nah, you haven't had it here.
No, I haven't. No, it's and crispy pork is my favorite.
Tammy, mark that. I want you to tell it.
Yeah. So is that Christy?
Christy. Yeah. I always thought it was a nightclub.
It actually is a nightclub at night. So what happens is...
What?
Yeah. Not a day club. It's a nightclub at night.
That makes sense. It's in the name.
Yeah. It's in the name. Asian Nights.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. So, but no, they actually do turn into a nightclub at the end of the day.
Is that by Northeast Mall?
It is not. It is Haltom City.
Okay, okay. Because there's, like, they got places over
I'll
there.
Say it. Oh, hey, Javi, it's in Haltom City.
It is in Haltom City.
I will remember.
I did.
Yeah, Asian so Nights.
But no, they do. They do karaoke sometimes. They have a full stage. It's actually pretty cool.
From the chat, my girlfriend knows that place. It's super delicious.
I Uber Eats it all the time. Well, that's Uber Eats, and you should probably DoorDash because it's free delivery and less fees.
Oh, ooh, man. Fun fact. Fun fact.
Fun fact. Pro tip.
Pro tip.
Moral of the story. I really
it's
hope
on
you,
beach
you
in 28th. Yes, it is.
Yeah, no, I
guess
think
who else is on beach in 28th soon?
What?
Me.
Really?
Well, yeah, eating Asian Night.
Oh, right. Okay. He's like, I'm
that's
moving.
That's my corner.
I'm moving the studio next door just so I can be close to it.
Like, I'm having a great time. It's been 50 minutes.
I've got to end this. Hang on. I've got to end this. I've got to end this segment. Shut up. That was News with Tim.
Hey, do sports real quick. Hold on. Do me real quick.
Hold on. Real quick.
You have something?
Wait, what? Everyone look at Javier and tell him that he needs to do what he just said.
You need to do what you just said. What
you legitimately need to stop working for someone else.
Chad,
and do you?
I do.
What did he just say?
He said he was going to, after all of the current work, he was going to figure out something else.
Okay.
Yeah,
do something else.
You're so much better than that.
It's interesting that you said that, though. With all the opportunity, there is so much opportunity out there when you open your eyes.
Yes.
And it is crazy because us as a world, sorry if you don't believe this, but I do, the world is here to keep your eyes closed so you stay grounded and nowhere.
I really thought you were going to say the world is a vampire.
World is a vampire.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say that. But seriously, take that time, take some leaps. That's what I did, and it's cool. And there's so many things to do out there. Right now is the entrepreneur's time to rise in this country.
We're in a cool
especially
time.
Texas. Yeah, Texas the spot for entrepreneurship because there's so many benefits and so many really cool things going on. And there's so many opportunities to do anything right now.
I will say one more thing for the news that an article came out that
it's
said
over.
That
the news is over. Bobby, you missed it. News is over.
I did say it was over.
He said, hey,
okay.
Dun, 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 that was the news.
Hold on, do it real quick. Do your thing.
News with Javi.
It's News with Javi.
Hey, so, you know, they said that Houston was like the second growing.
He's going to be like, we made it to the moon.
A little late there, bud.
Houston was the second growing biggest nation city in the country.
Nation station.
What's the first? Dallas-Fort Worth is number one when it comes to growth and like in
of
life and business.
Who's so, number one?
We are
to growth here.
Here, your penis.
Oh, facts. I've been watching it all night.
So
I'm thinking about In Time again and how like they have to like focus in on just keeping their time up. And that's, you know, and we're talking about doing that with the career. That's exactly what you're doing. It's like you're keeping focused on like work and not looking to the next.
Dude, I'm getting into work. Like I feel bad. Like Tammy's a trooper because I get up at 5:50 in the morning to get up and get ready, get to work at like 6.
Get up, domestic violence, breakfast. Let's hope that doesn't happen. Okay.
No.
All right. So you got sports.
Yeah. Real quick. Give it to me.
And now, Action Sports with Javier. Take it away, Javier.
Corey Seager got hurt in the fourth inning, I guess, and it's really bad. So the Rangers are doing really great right now, which I'm very surprised. And, you know, I know we're, like, almost at 500, but, you know, the Rangers are doing great, right?
Yeah.
But, like, the Mavericks are really suck. So the NBA is investigating them with, like, tanking, you know, controversy. And I hate it because, you know, at the start of this whole...
Wait a second. They're investigating them?
Yeah,
right
they're
now?
Investigating the Mavericks because they were accused of tanking. No fault to Kyrie Irving because he's been a great fucking player. He's like elevated the Mavericks to a different level. I'm very fucking pissed about it. You're wasting Luka's fucking talent. Mark Cuban, what the fuck are you doing? Like, what the fuck? Keep your eyes open. Like, this is really ridiculous. I don't want you to do the same thing you did with Dirk. Well, he's going to play like 20 seasons, but this isn't going to happen with fucking Luka because he's going to go to the fucking Lakers in like 2 years. So get your head out of your ass. And like fucking do something. That's it.
But hold on. But keep giving cheap prescriptions on drugs because
yeah,
that's
that.
Fucking amazing.
Fucking, yeah. Props to you, Mark Cuban. Like honestly,
away
like,
from basketball.
But yeah. Away from
basketball,
yeah.
Mark Cuban. Fuck off.
Yeah, fuck you, Mark Cuban.
Pharmaceutical, basketball. Mark Cuban. Yes.
Yes, you're doing great things for the people.
Wow. Well, I got a little bit of sports, yes. And so Panther City Lacrosse plays their last game April 21st. which is Friday. They're playing against the Roughnecks, Calgary Roughnecks.
Yeah.
And there's a possibility they might be going to the playoffs.
Woo!
Panthers of the Cross has done excellent this season. If you haven't gone, I recommend that you go. Please go out at some point. Also, I don't know if you know the price of season tickets for half season tickets for the Stars.
For the Stars?
Yeah.
I don't.
I looked into it. Oh. I was thinking maybe I'll get season tickets for next year.
Yeah.
Nah, man, I don't got $3,000 to spend for two tickets.
The Stars are going to the playoffs.
They're
going
to go to the playoffs.
$3,000?
For the section that I wanted to sit in, which is not even, like, it's just lower bowl.
I wanted to be on the fucking ice. $3,000 a piece.
It was lower bowl. It was lower bowl.
I better get a hand job from Jason Robertson.
On the edges is what I was looking at, and it was like three grand for a half season.
Wow.
The sit behind the bench was going to cost somewhere around like eight to ten, and I'm like, nah, there's no way. I can't
Holy
swing that.
Shit.
So instead, I'm going to probably get season tickets to Panthers of the Cross because it's a great time.
It actually, you know, I talked about how
it's a fun
it's
time.
Not super affordable. It has gotten very affordable like recently.
Yes.
Like you can do a whole ass like season ticket and you get to meet the team and all this shit and it's really good deal.
Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah. Anyways, that's my sports too. So that was Sports with Javier. Thank you, Javier.
Odell Beckham signed with the Ravens. Go fuck yourself, Odell.
Okay, we're done with sports. Turn it off.
Why are you so late today?
I don't know, man.
Okay, so let's get into the meat and potatoes.
Hey, Andrew from NEXM Creative over here.
Andrew again, guys.
God damn it, Paul. Fuck. See, man, I'm sorry, dude.
Know the name
dude,
of
I'm
our
sorry.
Guest.
No, yeah, I mean, you don't.
Yeah, I know.
I have a history with this man.
Okay, so. That's sexy.
Remember that store I told you I went to in a little secret tunnel?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was with
that's
Javi. That's where I met Javi.
I think we
he
all have.
He was demoing the urethral spreaders.
And also I was in Glory Hole 5. So
I think we all have some sort of history with Paul. I truly believe that I have bought something from you at some point in my life. Just because of where he worked up
can
before.
Can you not front me out like
that? Yeah, no, okay.
What
anyways.
The fuck?
Anyways. All right, so who is Paul?
Medicinal.
What? Who is Paul?
Paul is.
Hold on. We got to hit him with the Funky Five. What are you doing?
No. Let him do what he's doing. Who is Paul?
I want to know who Paul
is. What is Paul? Okay. Right. Who and what is Paul?
All right. What is a Paul?
I'm appalled now.
Damn it. Fuck off. Shut up. That's what I was going to say. I'm a Paul.
That's cute.
That's it?
Okay.
Yeah, me. That's a really fucking horrible leading question.
Yeah,
but cool. Yeah, no, me. I'm Paul.
So tell us a little bit about your backstory. Like you mentioned, you're from California. Mm-hmm. We know you as Daddy Paul from Uncorked a little bit with Corks and Cowtown. We also know you as the owner of NEXM Creative, the studio over there, kind of by Rockwood, right? I don't know what that area is called. What is that area called?
So they've coined it. Well, a business over there has coined it as Panther City District.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Right. Yeah, no.
Doesn't make any sense.
Then they were like, this is Panther City District. Give us money.
Yeah.
And I was like, what?
That's weird.
For being here?
Yeah.
I do. To the owner of the building. Fuck off.
Yeah, how does that work? Is it like
it's
a homeowners association type thing?
Kind of, yeah.
Weird.
They're trying to make it a HOA?
They are. Well, they're trying to make it another district. Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Okay.
I'm going to be quiet on that one.
Okay. Yeah.
I did hear a bunch of things about that, too.
So how did you get here to Fort Worth?
It is.
And how long ago was that?
A long time ago. I've been here most of my life.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. My mom married my stepdad, who's an amazing man.
Okay.
And I went to high school out here, went to college in Texas, went to college for opera singing.
No shit. Man, that's where the voice comes from. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
I mean, he's got the cheekbones and the lips for it.
Oh, he's got a lot of things for it. Yeah.
He really does.
Thanks. I actually had an extra 100 pounds with it as well, so it matched opera perfectly.
Oh, my.
Oh.
It's beautiful.
You love me a thick ball.
A thick ball or a thick Paul?
I mean, you know, it works.
They used to call
same.
Me Paul the Ball,
mm.
So that was fun. God thanks damn. For bringing that shit back.
All right, so Paul's been here for a little bit. He's been in Texas for a while.
So you were
from California.
Yeah, you were in music, opera.
Yeah.
But then you also had like bands and shit, right?
Yeah. Okay. So I just went to school for opera because it was free school.
Oh, okay.
That was it.
Because you were good. You were like, I'm good. I'm going to get free school.
Well, I just, yeah, sure.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very went cool.
Free school. That was fun. And then I always sung R&B and pop my whole life. And then went into rock for a little bit. I've been in sales and marketing and advertising forever.
Mm-hmm.
As you know, it's where I met you.
Yeah, yeah. We've known each other for a long time.
Sold you your first handy.
Yep, sure
Hey-o.
Did.
Hey, yo.
I'll tell you what, though,
the
man.
Crazy thing, it wasn't even my hand. That was the cool part. How fucking amazing am I? I made him pay me so he could give himself a handy. How about that shit?
Dude, it was the weirdest shit, man. Like, I couldn't believe it. I was like, paid. He loves me.
But you were into it.
And I went back to work. I'm like, what the fuck just happened?
That's right.
It was weird.
That's what I did.
So y'all met at the mall in the mall days.
Yeah. Ridgemar Mall.
Before there were no stores.
No, yeah.
Have you been there?
Yeah, it's very
creepy. Mm-hmm. Like they need to shoot some kind of zombie apocalypse or like a Dead Rising movie there.
Yeah.
So cool. Dustin Schneider over Jerry Jonestown Massacre, he does photography on the side.
Yeah.
And he went out to shoot the mall and they kicked him out. They were like, no, you can't take pictures here. And threw him out of the mall because
heaven forbid you have one extra patron.
They don't
in your fucking right. empty ass mall.
Well, the guy didn't want him to like. He's like, I don't. This we're not gonna have this end up on Dead Malls of America's Twitter or whatever.
What?
Yeah, there's some Twitter about dead malls.
So the security of Ridgemar Mall are more scared about the fact they're going to be on some Twitter account about
dead
malls.
Because then it might attract the wrong type of crowd. I don't know.
But there's no one going in there.
You know what also
attracts
the wrong kind of crowd?
An empty mall?
An empty fucking mall. There's no stores.
Have you?
Like, there are no stores.
Have you heard what they're going to do with it? They're going to turn it into...
Possibly.
Possibly turn it into condos. They're going to revamp the entire inside of it and make it... It's like
that sounds like a great idea.
This big...
Stores don't want to be here, so let's live here.
Right. Yeah. But
I love
gonna,
that.
Then they're going to put stores there, and so they'll have condos and stores, and it's going to cater to us, our generation... Because we grew up going to malls. Think about it.
I will never live in a mall.
You wouldn't live in a mall?
No.
Fuck no.
Can I ask you, what's your favorite memory in that mall?
You're trying to get me to say you, aren't you?
I mean, I'm trying. I mean, I was there all the time.
Like, I did come talk to you. I used to leave the buckle and come right to you, buddy.
Oh, man.
You were in what, T-Mobile?
Yeah.
I would go down there. I'd hang out for a long time.
Yeah.
I'm special. I'm so special.
I'll tell you what I miss about that mall is the pizza. But you get it up and didn't, so it's
Sabaro? No, it wasn't Sabaro.
No,
it was like a Sabaro knockoff, but a local version.
Really. Yeah.
You know they're in Denton.
The
same people.
The one from Ridgemar moved to Denton. They're in the mall in Denton.
Oh, no shit.
The same people.
We went with our friend Angie.
The same dude? Like same the dude. Same guy?
Yes, the slick black haired
dude. Yes.
He's still over there.
The whole family. Black hair still? Or is it gray now?
He dyes it.
Okay.
But, you know.
The whole family.
The wife is there. Yeah. Like, I mean, it's weird.
Dude, I used to get pasta there all the time because they would make sausage and peppers because that's like I'm Italian, so that was my Italian shit.
We made her cry.
Yeah,
we showed up there and we're like, this is our childhood. We grew up eating this pizza.
Oh, I'm glad.
At Ridgemar. And then she was like, oh,
she cried.
Yeah,
she
so she's like, so you live up here now? And didn't I was like, no, we drove all the way up here because we heard that you're here. And she was like, oh my gosh.
Shout out to Angie over at Better Like Let's
Got all teary eyed and everything. So
we need to do that again, Angie, by the way. We need to have a whole day of food and beer again. That was a fun
day. All right, so now that we understand just a little bit about Paul.
Yeah, not really. I didn't say much.
All
right, thanks, guys, for having me on the show. It's been so much fun.
No, that was episode 130 with Paul.
I'm gonna fix your mic here. Let's tighten
it up. But what's the coolest...
Oh, tighten it up.
What's the coolest thing you experienced over there at the mall whenever you worked
over
there?
You're killing me.
Sorry, buddy.
You're just really digging into this whole mall situation.
I like malls, man.
All right.
I'm sorry. Okay.
Paul in the mall.
Can we move on?
Yeah, let's move on.
All right.
Go ahead.
So we normally we jump into the Funky Five. Chad, I think you should take us down this pathway on what is the Funky Five.
All right. So we do this little thing with the guests that we really like. We do this little thing with guests that come onto the show for the first time called the Funky Five. It's just kind of five rapid fire questions. That we just need you to answer first thing that comes to your head. Don't need to put too much thought on it. They're all local. It's not like, who would you? You know what I mean? Like, what is your favorite color? Would be like one. What's your favorite color?
Red.
Perfect. Me too.
Wait.
Oh, God damn
Hold
it.
Hold on.
No.
Red as a color, but blue to wear.
Oh, okay. Right. Yeah.
See how that wasn't rapid fire, though? Because you had to have an explanation. So kind of tweak that up a little bit. Just make it red.
I think I'd like you in a peach. I think I'd like you in a peach.
All right. Question number one.
Salmon.
What is your favorite Fort Worth restaurant?
My favorite?
Your favorite Fort Worth restaurant. Don't make fun of me. It makes me real self-conscious.
You should be real self-conscious.
God damn.
Last time I heard, you didn't have a job, but...
Fuck!
Fuck me, right? And that was Paul, everybody. Thanks for coming on the show, Paul.
Favorite restaurant in Fort Worth?
Yeah, yeah.
Fort Worth or surrounding cities?
Fort Worth. And surrounding cities.
Asian Nights, baby. Okay. Asian fucking Nights. Hey, listen, if you listen to Asian Nights, please sponsor my guys here at the Funky Panther because we will eat all of your insides.
My guy
of food. Yes.
I've eaten ass before, so I mean, I'm not opposed to it.
All right.
Just send us pad thai every Tuesday night at the Funky Panther.
Hey, real quick, shout out to Day and Night Watch Company.
Okay.
They're really run by a really good man.
Okay.
Really good friend of mine.
Really?
Man, hey, it's an incredible watch company.
Where are they located?
Where are they located?
Yeah.
Well, they're all over the place.
Really?
Yeah, it's a Day and Night Watch Company. Look it up.
Oh, okay.
It's amazing. Luxury watches for a fraction of the price.
My dad loves watches. Like, he's always...
He got serious.
He's...
Wait, my dad. My father.
My father.
The person that spurted me out of his testicle sack... Loves watches.
The man who invented toaster strudels would not appreciate the fact that you did not address the news that there's a watch company that he would like.
Day and Night Watch Co. says Dallas, Texas. So that's there is a location. Thanks, Paul.
Checking out their website. A highly successful watch brand at an affordable price. They've been featured on NBC Digital Journal, Fox, Voyage, Dallas.
Very true. And not
Oracle
the,
Time.
And
we
not
buy.
To toot the family horn, but toodly-doo, my son... takes a lot of his product photography.
Oh, very cool.
Because my son is a photographer.
Your son does a lot of good work. Like, you know, he's starting out.
Photography.
And you're teaching him, yeah.
Okay, thank
starting
you.
Out photography.
Just want to make sure we didn't Dalai Lama this thing up.
Okay, moving right. on. Moving on. Question number two.
Question number two.
Favorite forward drinking spot?
Drinking spot?
Yeah.
I like a good Chimmy's.
Yeah.
I really like it. Only because I experienced it with you.
Oh, it was nice.
It was.
We had the Dr. Pepper shootouts, DP shootouts.
I'd never done one before.
There's just one thing I like. It's DP.
I bet that's true.
It is true. All right. Favorite local musician?
I shouldn't have said that.
We just moved on. Yeah. That was
I like a good DP. It's...
Well, I just found my next watch, so thank you.
Shut up, Tim. Favorite.
Shut up, Tim.
Favorite.
Mom, meatloaf.
Favorite local musician.
You know what? Someone that no one's ever heard of besides myself is.
It's you, isn't it?
No, it's not. It's not. No, bubbly. No. It is a hip hop artist named Hani Zine. Z-E-I-N. Probably one of the most incredible rappers I've ever heard.
Here in Fort Worth?
Yeah.
No shit.
No shit. I'm gonna show you some of this stuff because he was an artist of mine for a while.
Yeah.
He was doing some work and stuff, hadn't been in the studio in a little bit, but one of the most incredible I compare him not sound wise, but I compare him to a Busta Rhymes.
Okay.
But the only reason I say that, he's nothing like Busta Rhymes, but you know how no one could ever be Busta Rhymes?
Right.
That's how he is.
Very cool.
It is insane. I'm going to show you guys his music because he is ridiculous.
Nice. Sounds good. Question number four. What is your favorite podcast?
You
that one doesn't have to be local. Just like something that you listen to on the regular.
I don't listen to podcasts.
At all.
I produce them.
I know.
All day long.
Yeah.
And I don't listen to them.
Oh, I actually have questions for you regarding the podcast that you have over there. Because talking about podcasts. You know, we were talking about...
Like, I do like the Funky Panther quite a bit. You know what?
This isn't a poll. This isn't a poll.
No.
No, I actually like the Funky Panther because like I do like that. But it's very hard for me to listen to podcasts. Just kind of like it's very hard for me to listen to music outside of the recording studio.
Right.
Yeah, I listen to a lot of nothing.
Right.
Silence. I have music in my head all day. It's very hard for me to sit and listen to people talk after listening to people talk all day long.
What's your life soundtrack?
My life? soundtrack.
Yeah.
Which changes per minute.
But like, what's the main thing?
Like literally in the gym, yeah. I've gone from piano to soft R&B to opera to hip hop to Static X kind of heavy metal.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Oh yeah, I love some Static X, man. Wayne Static. Yeah. Fire. Anyways. Yeah, sorry. I'm not really a rapid fire kind of guy.
Yeah, right. Either is Javier. So, well, usually. But all right, what? Moving on to the very last question. Tim's going to take us.
I'm going to set you up with this one.
Set me.
You're right. Going to grow a glory hole, and you're going to.
So imagine going back in time whenever you didn't have DVR.
I think Robin should not be able to comment. Block her now.
I know.
This is so rapid fire.
We're going to get rid of her.
We're going to get rid of her right now.
Imagine going back in time to where you didn't have DVR, you didn't have DirecTV, you didn't have cable, you didn't have any of that stuff, no streaming services. You're flipping through the channels.
Oh, wait. Okay.
You're flipping through the channels, and you come across that one movie that's playing on, like, channel 39 or whatever.
How old am I?
It's just your favorite movie. What is your favorite movie of all time? The one that you're going to stop and watch no matter where it's at.
Probably any of the Lethal Weapons.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
I would fucking love Lethal Weapon.
I'm with you on that one. If it's on TV, I'm going to stop.
Yeah. Or Terminator. I'm a down for Terminator 2. Terminator 1 kind of drags on for a bit.
Yeah.
I love Terminator 2, but I love Lethal Weapon. Did you see they're making a 5?
Yes. Yeah.
Fucking excited.
Yeah, it's going to be really cool. I'm very excited.
I'm excited, but I'm also...
Aroused.
I'm also holding my breath a little bit because I just don't want it to... I don't want them to ruin it.
Dude. They can't. It's like they will never ruin John Wick.
I didn't think they could ruin
John Wick will go on forever, and I will watch it.
It's true. So
good. I'm not going to see an Academy Award winning movie. I'm going to see Mel Gibson and Danny Glover that's doing shit that
I didn't think they could
do.
Ruin Indiana Jones, and then they made the Crystal Skull. So
hey, look. Like, go
well, they're making another one of those, too.
It looks really good. It looks really good.
Does it?
Yeah, it does.
Well, that would really be a great marketing ploy to put a horrible preview out to make it look bad.
Oh. Well, congratulations. You made it through not so rapid Funky Five.
Yeah, I really do apologize about the rapid thing. But, you know, whenever you were talking about watching MTV back in the day, I used to watch the Playboy Channel. Now, I'm going to ask you guys this. We didn't have the Playboy Channel, of course, but the Playboy Channel was on the channels. Right, so when you used to watch it, if you had one of the dial knob TVs, because it would be,
yeah.
So you could slow down the tracking, and then it would be like scene, titty, gone. Scene, titty, ass, oop,
yeah,
gone. So and then you could do it, and every once in a while, I'd be like, just out of nowhere, it'd be like, it was pretty crazy.
You know, the thing that I wanted, the thing I tried to get on like the most when I was growing up was the Pam. And Tommy.
I think I can help with this whole Pam situation.
Oh.
But it was a Pam Tommy tape. I was like trying to like focus on that and just like a nipple. Or
so
something
did
like
you
that.
Know that on DirecTV you could rent movies, right?
Right.
Did you know they gave you previews before you rented it to make sure that you liked it?
Yeah.
Did you know they did that with all the softcore porn that was on there?
No shit.
I found that out and made a compilation tape.
No way.
Oh, yeah. You just go to all the different ones and make a VHS tape.
So
it
wasn't just like the storyline or anything? You like got the good stuff?
You just get like the first part of it.
Right.
But it was like, go straight like,
I'm here to fix your faucet. So his mixtape is only people like showing up to do a job they never do.
Shirt comes off. They start doing the deed and it cuts, you know, it's 5 minutes, five minute preview. So you get like the first 5 minutes get hooked into is what the whole idea was.
I just
was.
Need three.
That's and so then you just go and I'd made it.
30 seconds. I know myself.
I made a compilation tape of it.
But I mean, how I like awful that. Would that be to watch if you're actually looking for the content? You know what I mean? Like, oh, I really want to know what's going to happen. And then it just cuts over to another one. I mean, that's kind of shitty.
Well, I mean, as a...
Speaking of softcore porn,
13-year-old,
did you know that the Blockbuster website's back up?
Yes.
Yeah, we talked about that on the last episode.
We did.
If you listen, know what? I know I don't listen to this sorry ass podcast, know. But know. You know what I'm saying? No, but the reason I said that is because I was going to ask you a question. Do you think it's actually Blockbuster?
Man, I don't know. I'm kind of thinking it might be the Radio Shack debacle where it's maybe a cryptocurrency or something along those lines. Because that's what Radio Shack
was doing. Ryan Reynolds bought it. That's what I want to have.
They're making
happen.
A movie. Maybe they're making a movie.
Well, you know they had the Blockbuster. I actually really liked the
documentary.
The show?
No, the actual show
on Netflix?
With what's his name? The guy from
the Asian guy from the
Marvel.
Yeah,
from, I thought it was pretty cool. Like because I used to work at Blockbuster when I was 15 and 16, and it was fucking awesome. I loved it. 16, 17.
Was it here in Fort Worth?
Yeah.
Which
off
one?
Of McCart.
Oh, McCart. You worked at the McCart one.
Alta Mesa and McCart.
Yes, I used to go to that one.
No
that,
shit.
That's the one I went
oh
to.
Oh, my God. They had movies.
Yeah, they did.
And popcorn.
Yeah, they did. And music. They had CDs.
Yeah, I don't remember that.
I mean, that was the. I was in.
It was, I went to the Ephraim Avenue one.
Yeah.
That was my Blockbuster. Yeah. All right. Anyways. All right, back on Paul. So
Paul, you ended where you were into music. You were in multiple bands. You were in rock bands, right?
I was, yeah.
How did you get from the rock band situation to like creating NEXM Creative Studio?
Yeah, so I like I said, I've been in marketing, advertising, sales my whole life.
Yeah,
I've always been a high performer in all those, and one day, at the very last position I was ever at. There was a turn of events, and it was just time for me to get out.
Yeah.
It just was time. And then when I walked out the doors of that place, as I was walking to my car from leaving my previous employer of 30 seconds.
Your last employer you've had.
My last employer I've ever had.
Other than yourself.
Right.
Wow.
I said, I'm never going to do this anymore. I got tired of the varying moral compass of companies.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I don't like how a company banks on fucking people over.
Right.
And that's probably why my company now isn't as big as it could be, but I get to sleep at night.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
So you mean you're not fucking people over?
No, I can't.
That's really nice.
And it's like, dude, like I've even had the intrusive thoughts of thinking like, you know what? I could easily do this.
Mm-hmm.
And be like every other business, and I just can't do it. My I can't.
Yeah.
Like, I get too invested in all of my people that walk in the door.
Yeah.
You know, it's interesting. So I started from there. I started a recording studio. I've always been into recording music because I got fucked over in studios so many times that I was like, I'll just record my own music and put it out myself because, you know, I just did it. So then people started asking for studio time, yada, yada. Had it in my back room at my mom's house, I think, when I was super young. And then I always had a little studio in my house. And I was like, yeah, I'll just start a recording studio. Found out very quickly recording engineers make shit money.
Really?
Yeah.
Horrible money. So I was broke for 4 years. It's pretty much my story. I was broke for 4 years. And then somebody, I was in Haltom City, and I was in an office building in Haltom City, and I was in a little 100-square-foot little office. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
And I built, they let me, I just fucking did it, and they just had to be okay with it. I built my own little recording booth. Shout out to Carl Edwards, one of my greatest friends. He spent days and days and sleepless nights building this like really professional soundproof booth. And then someone came in and said, hey, I need a podcast. And I was like, yeah, I can do that shit because I'm a yes man.
Right.
You know, I saw. I'll find a way. And fuck, I had to find a way. I really did. So they were like, hey, you know, we want to do a podcast and I was like, okay, easy. And they're like, yeah, we've got three different people on the show. And I was like, yeah, I could. I got that set up. I'm good. So then it forced me. I said, yep, I can do it.
Which is not viable in a 100-square-foot space, right?
No, or a 5x7 booth. Right. So I was like, this is going to be the start of a really poorly produced porn. Or I need to make a change. Right?
Yeah.
So he booked for the following week. So I had 3 days to set up an entire podcast studio.
Yeah.
So I went down to the owners of the building and I said, I need another space now. I'll pay for it. Here we go. I just scrounged up some money and I was like, let me just do it. Called a buddy of mine. We built a desk. We built a backdrop. I spent shit tons of money on all this stuff. Got a couple of credit cards. I was like, fuck it. I'm going to just make it happen. Built a really nice little podcast studio for what it was in this one little room. It was about 140 square feet, 150 square feet. So it was longer, though. So it was like a big rectangle. So they were at the very end, and I was at the far end recording them. Set it up. Next week, they came in, ran it, right? So I started doing podcasts, you know. So I just, like I said with the whole yes man thing, I firmly believe in that. I believe that you never allow someone else, if you're capable,
right,
never allow someone else to do what you're capable of doing without at least trying.
Right.
You know, because what's the worst that can happen? It does, you don't do very well.
You fail. Well. You look like a big idiot.
Who cares?
Yeah.
I love failing. You know how many times I've failed? Every failure, I don't believe in the word failure as the negative connotation. I love failing. I tell my son this all the time. Please fail, because then you teach yourself and you are able to look at things in a different way, mm-hmm. and say, okay, that didn't work. I need to pivot. I need to move. I need to evolve. I need to change to make it work. Because what you did wasn't a failure.
Right.
The way you did it was a failure.
Right.
Right? So you failed in the way that you did it. One way. Let's do it a different way.
So not only is it a learning experience, which a lot of people think of just like, oh, it's a learning experience, but it's also a growing experience, because you're going to be less likely to be scared of that failure in the future, right? And so you get more comfortable with the fact that it's okay to take risks, right?
So I equate it, mm-hmm. to performing, mm-hmm. on stage, right? When you first do it, it's terrifying. Mm-hmm. But you keep doing it and keep doing it and keep doing it, even though you don't want to. You keep doing it and keep doing it, and you're fine. Dude, yeah. I can get on a stage right now and just go in front of 10,000 people, and I love it. That's a rush for me. It's so much fun, right? But it's because I accepted the fact that I can only do what I can do, mm-hmm. but I'm going to put everything I have in that one instance forward.
I love
that.
Not
going to leave anything behind, right? Hell yeah. So I did that, started this podcast studio, started getting some more clients, because podcasts started booming, yeah. right in, yeah. 2019.
Yeah.
Podcasts started like really, they've been around since like 2005,
right.
or 2008, I think. And
it's like RSS feeds and stuff like,
yeah,
that.
Yeah, no, yeah. And it was, but it wasn't widely listened to. So I was like, I think I've got something here, right? COVID happened, right? And I could have done one of two things. I could have allowed COVID to make me fail, to go back, bankruptcy, all this kind of stuff. Oh, well, it's not going to work out. Or I could do what I did. Is I, failure like that, like COVID, I didn't look at it as a failure, as a stop business thing, right? Mm-hmm. So I looked into some of the laws, and I contacted the city, and I said, hey, I'm 6 feet away from, or actually I'm like 10 feet away from my clients, and there's only one of me and one of them. Can I still operate as a business? And they said, yeah, that's totally fine, as long as you're at least 10 feet away or in a separate room. And by that time, I had made that one room into two rooms, and I put a wall and glass there, like a studio room, right?
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Like a booth. That way, you know, I could, you know, talk or whatever to people that they, my next client or whatever, so they wouldn't hear. So they said, yeah, you can operate a business. They gave me a permit and all this kind of stuff during COVID, because they were handing those out for only certain frontline workers, mm-hmm. and people that could prove safety. So I was one of those proven safety ones, because I did it. And then I started noticing, as I was doing these podcasts and people were doing it, because people had a lot to say in that time. I was driving around. When I drive from home to work and back and wherever I was going, I noticed that businesses that I had seen since I was a kid were shutting down. Mm-hmm. It was the weirdest feeling,
right,
seeing that, you know? Like big businesses that I thought were big were just shutting down. Yeah. All of a sudden, they were just gone. Signs gone. Windows boarded up. And so I started looking online for these businesses. And I was like, they don't have any content. They have nothing online. They banked on people knowing them from long ago.
And coming in person.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I said, this is it. This is what I need to do. And I was, the office building I was in, there was a country music station channel down at the very bottom of the floor, and I would help them with audio, because I've been audio engineer now for like 22 years, almost 23 years now. And I would help them with audio stuff, and they were kind of, I was learning a lot of the video from them, and I was meeting some really cool people on these gigs, right? Mm-hmm. So one of the and I don't think anyone here has met him, but his name is David, and he's my your favorite. He's my DP. He's my director of photography. Not your favorite kind, yes. But hey, at least it's a DP. You can at least
DP
claim
for
it.
Me is A OK.
That's right. All right. DP shootout's a whole other thing for you guys.
Hey-o.
Hey-o. Lots of DPs. Let's have fun Saturday night.
He deep throws.
So that's
oh my God.
Moving on. That went. Okay. So I met him and started just kind of picking his brain for years. So I was in that one little studio space, those couple of studio spaces, for about 4 years. And the first 2 years were starving from music, not doing anything. Last 2 years were that. And it was funny because I opened my studio a little bit over 2 years ago, the one that I have now that you guys have been to.
It's fucking beautiful, yeah.
Well, I appreciate that. And so 3.5, 4 years ago, I designed it in my brain. And I said, this is what I'm going to have. Literally to the T. You can ask Robin because she knows this because I was talking to her about it whenever she came in to do a podcast at my studio to be a guest on a podcast, right?
Okay.
I told her exactly what it was going to be like. And sure enough, I built it. So COVID happened. I noticed that people needed content. And I said, that's where I need to go. I need to create content, not only podcasts, but be able to make people more visible at an affordable price, right? Because that's the thing. It's like it's either Marvel or horrible quality.
Yeah.
Like, because that's what we see every day.
Right.
That's what we've been seeing Iron Mans and these Marvel movies, which is probably some of the most incredible cinematics and graphics and, you know, special effects you'll ever see.
Right.
Or you've got these.
For the cost, for the price.
Or you've got Saul Goodman type commercials.
Right.
Right. You know, you got stuff like that. Right. So I was like.
So you're somewhere in between is what you're saying.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm right in between. Right in the middle. So I was.
The question is, can you do Saul Goodman type commercials?
Shit, yes, I can. Shit, yes, one word. Okay. Shit, yes. All one word. I can.
I might have some ideas.
Oh, my God. I love that shit. So then you know, I already got my balls up to start my own thing, and they were kind of shrinking down because I was making no money. Then they started getting a little bigger because I was like, okay, I'm making a little bit of money now, and then COVID happened, and then I just pushed. I said, now's the good a time as any to just fucking go.
Yeah.
So I did, and I did it too soon, but it's okay, but I fought for it. I had a goal. I did it. I had my studio built for me. I found it took me probably a year to find a good spot. It's a 3,000 square foot warehouse. It was completely empty. Literally, I'm sorry. It wasn't completely empty. I had them gut it because it was just disgusting. It was like a woodworking cabinet shop.
Okay.
Wow. Cabinet little thing. I had them gut everything. The owner of the building was gracious enough to allow me to pay off the build out. Which was, I couldn't have done without it. I mean, I credit all everything I have now to that opportunity to be able to do that. So I built it the way that I wanted to build it.
Mm-hmm.
I spent, with Kate, I spent 6.5, 7 hours in a Starbucks in San Antonio. We did, together. And we designed every single inch of that place, like literally down to the inch to make sure everything would fit. And we got it to the builder, and he goes, all right, we'll do it. Of course, this is COVID, you know, so supplies. It took us, I guess, a little over a year to build the place out, right? Mm-hmm. And he said, this guy has been a GC forever, a general contractor forever, and he said, I've never seen so much insulation in one place in my life. And he goes, and I've built skyscrapers.
Because you need it for, you know.
For sound.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I built NEXM Creative, and it has developed into something that I never.
Was it NEXM before you moved in there, or did it become NEXM when you got in that spot?
So I came up with NEXM in that little spot.
Okay.
I just started. I was battling between NEXM Creative and NEXM Agency, and NEXM is just a four-letter word that looks cool on a shirt, literally.
Yeah.
So it was like I was all over the internet looking at all these random business generators, name generators, and I looked up, it was like Next Generation Media, NEXM. I was like, four letters, like Nike. I was like, hell yeah, that's kind of cool. NEXM, NEXM, not NEXUM. I was like, that's too many.
Yeah.
Four letters, easy to divide apart, easy to make a logo with. I made this shitty little logo, which actually is only one iteration from where it is now, which is funny because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I just put a whole bunch of damn shapes together, right? And I was like, there's my logo and there's my LLC and it's great. So then I did that, and now fast forward to where it is today, I've got NEXM Creative, NEXM Sports, about to open up a creative agency with NEXM Creative because why not?
Yeah.
You know, just the idea, the consultant, because I'm an idea guy.
Right.
Before I did all this stuff, I used to go to businesses and talk to their marketing departments and just give them ideas for random shit because I've got ADD like crazy, but I've been able to channel it in more of a creative way and just right. spit out ideas. And if I don't spit them out, then they're just bogged down in my brain and then I can't focus.
Right.
But if I spit them out and regurgitate them to people that could possibly use them, cool. Almost like a consultant.
Yeah.
So did that, and I'm looking at just really expanding, and it's been so cool. I've been able to be a part of some really amazing things in Fort Worth. I love Fort Worth, and they've welcomed me with, you know, one open arm, you know, for the most part.
Yeah.
You know, and I think it's because there's so many media companies here. There's just so many production companies out here because yeah. it's so big. The DFW and Fort Worth is just growing so fast. But I've worked with some amazing people, man. Like, I built this place.
And big companies.
Yeah, man. I've worked with people that I never thought in a million years I would work with.
So I want to go down the list of, like, who you've worked with. You've worked with TX Whiskey, Madden 21.
Yeah.
AT&T, Freakonomics Radio, PBS. Yep.
Disney Plus.
Jameson, DraftKings, Showtime, Barbasol, Fox Sports, or Fox, and Visit Fort Worth. But like, also, you've
done
like a Pornhub, right?
Well, I was the actor, so okay. I don't really count that.
Continue, my bad.
But like, okay. also, you were doing a recording here recently with LeGarrette, right?
LaMonica Garrett from AC83.
Yeah.
Last week, I was in the studio with Barry Pepper, who you may not know that name.
Yes, Saving Private Ryan. And,
yes, yo, and dude, was Knock on, Around Guys.
Yeah. And, oh, I fucking loved him, Knock dude, Around Guys.
Such a good movie. He was in the studio recording episode 2 of Showtime All Access for the Ryan Garcia and Tank
Fight.
I
just found out that he did that. Yes. I had no idea.
He was in my studio because, recording episode 2.
I loved That's watching.
Awesome. It's like, fucking cool, man.
Like me and my best friend watched the Showtime stuff for boxing because that's like what we really get into.
Oh, dude. Their All Access is like, it's like this crazy cool new way. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, dude. It is done so well. Yeah. It's like this, it almost reminds me of like kind of a video game. Like how like the story mode because it's so badass. Like it is so freaking cool how they've got it. They've got you know with Tank and Ryan Garcia.
Right.
They've got this whole like going back and forth with all their training, what they're doing, their lives, their misfortunes, their triumphs. Dude, it's so cool.
April 22nd, by the way.
Like, April 22nd, Las Vegas. Yeah. Yes,
right.
Anyways, so yeah, and you know I had David Oyelowo. Who played Martin Luther King in Selma. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He is in a new movie with Kaley Cuoco and Billy Bob Thornton. He was in the studio.
I hated him in that one movie with the Planet of the Apes movie because he was a real fucking asshole.
Yes, he was.
Yeah.
But,
however,
he's a really nice guy. Yeah.
Dude, he is one of the most down-to-earth, sweetest, most the most incredible energy people. And he's got this silky freaking English British accent, and he did this narration for a PBS wildlife show about forest fires and the wildlife that emerges from these forest fires. It was the most incredible thing I've ever heard. I was just like, you know, people tell me about my voice, and I'm like, fuck off. I was like, I don't hear that, right? Because I hear my own voice. I'm like, ugh, gross, you know. But I hear this dude's voice. I'm like, holy shit.
Yeah.
So now I know why people like it.
So who's blown you away? Like the people you've had in the studio. Like, dude, I know. Oh,
Eric Nelson from AC83. Yeah, I've worked with him, he and his wife, and they're so fucking cool.
Yeah, we met him at a
incredible humans.
Yeah.
I do have a quick question.
Yeah.
What is the rule on urination?
You can go if you want to go pee right now.
I have
now,
to pee right
pee.
Now. Okay, real quick.
I was like waiting. I was waiting.
You saw me moving around a lot, right?
That's pretty normal.
So
I feel
so
like
it happens. But again, like we have
So we've been to Paul's studio a few times now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah,
we had the opportunity to, we've talked about it a couple times on the podcast. He was Daddy Paul and recorded the entire Uncorked episode that we did as guests on Uncorked, which is Corks in Cowtown, our friend Robin. And so he's kind of in the background as Daddy Paul. He recorded the whole thing. He puts it all together. He works with her on all of her podcasts. He obviously does a lot, and his studio is amazing.
Yeah, it's very nice and pretty.
It's one of the best spots.
It's got some cool stuff.
Honestly, yeah, it really
nice
is.
It's very nice and pretty.
It's one of the premier places to record, to shoot photography, to
hang out.
It's like my new hangout spot, honestly.
Like, honestly, one of the best places in Fort Worth. I know, like, we talk up a lot of places, but, like, this place is a place where you want to do your business whenever you need to, like, do photography.
While, when it comes while to, he's in there, I mean, might as well just pull this up. So we had a
picture of his dick? Yes! Yes! Thank you, Jesus! All right, go on. Let me see it.
No.
Let me see that thing.
No, we had a, what's it called?
Yeah, no.
A voice message, voicemail.
Oh, okay. Wait, hold on. He's back.
He's back.
We're going to go ahead and play it. So we've got a voicemail. We do have a phone number, 817-677-0408. And someone left us a voicemail last week. And so we're going to go ahead and play that real quick. And I think it was a question. Wasn't it a question?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, Funky Panther. This is John from Data with John, the Instagram account.
Oh, hey.
So I have a question for you guys. What podcasts do you listen to? Not local podcasts, just as professional podcasters, what podcasts do you find inspirational or enjoyable? I'd love to hear it.
All right, so I pre-listened to that before because I wanted to have an idea of what it was, and then I got a few things. I got a few things. So I listened to Dungeons and Daddies.
He said inspirational.
My son listens to that.
He said,
oh, does he really?
He said
he
just,
really does.
Or what
he
you
loves
find
it.
What you find enjoyable. So Dungeons and Daddies, I listened to that one.
Oh, you know what would be cool if he came out whenever we did our thing for.
Yeah, we might have to do that. Yeah. So yeah, Dungeons and Daddies.
Okay.
This is not. I mean, it is kind of local. So I'm gonna just say it. The Treehouse Podcast. It was. Back whenever they were on the radio, it was the Russ Martin Show. They've now had this transition to a podcast format. It's called the Treehouse Podcast. That one's one of my favorites to listen to. And then if I want a good laugh, the Adam Friedland Show, I do enjoy that.
Formerly the Cumtown Podcast.
Formerly known as Cumtown. And then I got really into like Sword and Scale and stuff like that. But those are the big ones for me.
I've never really gotten into the talk show radio, which is, you know, type podcast, which is funny because that's kind of what we do. But I've always been very much into like learning type podcasts. Like whenever you and I used to brew,
yeah.
I used to be really into
brewing up a business or whatever. And
yeah. Jerk off, man. You know, like
the,
all that stuff.
There was a sour beer podcast that was really good. But recently it's been My First Million, right? My First Million. Yeah. My First Million. They talk about business concepts. They talk about, you know, with entrepreneurs and like millionaires, billionaires. They have them on the show and they talk about different opportunities and things. They're talking a lot about AI right now because it's just the opportunities are fucking crazy.
It's
and
scary.
How, like, one of the guys they had on the show this past week, he literally bought chat.com for, was it like over, it was like eight. He didn't say how much. He didn't disclose how much, but it was an eight-digit number that he paid for chat.com because he doesn't know what he's going to use it for yet, but he knows that AI is the future. And with ChatGPT and all these things happening where you can chat in and have things happen, he knows that that word is going to be that important that he bought chat.com. So just like hearing about all these different stories, things like that, My First Million is really the only one that I'll listen to other than local podcasts. Javier?
You know, I listen to Two Bears, One Cave, like Tom Segura and Bert Kreischer.
Yeah.
Fucking hilarious. Love those guys. In the more serious like realm, I listen to Last Day. It's more of a like type of podcast where it like chronicles overdoses or suicides. You know, the last day they're alive and like what they went through. For me, like something that I loosen up with is Three Gossip Girls. Like they go through every episode of Gossip Girl, including the new reboot, which, you know, as you all know, which you've probably already known, I love Gossip Girl, you know,
This is an actual show. Are you joking?
No, it's three girls talking about. They go through each episode of Gossip Girl and they critique it and they talk about it. And
it's
like Mystery
Science Theater, right?
Yeah, exactly.
But you actually listen to this. This is something
I do.
Really...
This is something I listen to. It's a really good podcast, man. And like I've really enjoyed. And I've not listened to the newer episodes. Like when it comes to the new reboot, like I want to wait for that.
Right.
Because I'm still going through their episodes, but it's a very cool and very good. Last Day was like the most serious one, but I mean they're really good podcasts.
So Chad, you're talking about the episode though, talking about all the AI stuff, what it could do. I think I found the audio that I created using AI, and it's pretty creepy.
I gotta go try the weasel.
Okay, have fun.
Let me make sure this works.
It's going to take forever because, you know, what's I was happening? Trying to.
This is Tim from the only podcast you should be listening to, which is the Funky Panther. When I'm not sitting at home thinking about sleep or in bed, actually sleeping, I'm out at my favorite bar, Down and Out, drinking a wonderful, delightful, dare I say, downright tasty Funky Panther Shandy and listening to Insane Clown Posse while sitting in the corner of the bar contemplating my life and where everything went wrong. Anyway, remember to like and subscribe, I guess, and be sure to check out the Down and Out Bar, which is located at 150 West Rosedale Street in Fort Worth, Texas. Stay good.
That's interesting.
That's all AI?
So it's all AI, and I did it with I took a very short copy of my voice.
Like you read a paragraph and...
No, I just took... I record multi-track, and so I just pulled my isolated audio, cut it up, and then fed it just a few clips and did instant cloning. You can get a little bit more advanced and make it sound a little bit more close to your actual voice.
Yeah,
sounded like you, dude.
I mean, I know I've known you long enough to know it was pretty far off, but I can only imagine that you load a little bit more time of your voice into that, and it's just going to get better and better.
I showed you the Kanye West thing, right?
That was nuts.
Dude.
Yeah. And then
Day and Night.
Hey, this is Chad from the award-winning podcast, The Funky Panther.
I don't sound like that.
When I'm not out traveling the world, I'm at my favorite street corner whoring myself out for money to support my traveling habits. When I'm not doing that, I'm at my favorite bar, Nickel City. You can catch me pounding beers and slamming down some sliders at Nickel City. Remember, if you see me out, be sure to say hi. And if you want a quick hand job, slip me a $5 bill and give me a wink.
Ten.
I'll know what to do.
It's 10
Anyways,
now.
Anyways, remember to listen.
It's 3.
Sure I know my worth.
Subscribe to our YouTube and Instagram. It would really mean a lot.
Yeah, so that was just with this, just like a short 20-minute or 20-second clip.
Please tell me you have Javier.
I don't have Javier's, but we have one that
Jerry Jonestown Massacre did, a couple of Javier. And they were, I mean, they loaded a ton of audio, I think, didn't they?
I gave him 4 hours of Javier to cut up.
And it was pretty damn close. Like, that one was pretty damn close.
Yeah, and so I'm going to keep messing with it, and I'm gonna keep bringing it up and seeing what I can do. But it's insane what you can do with AI. And just think about it in a NEXM Creative type thing, right?
It's insane what you can do with an asshole, too.
So you get somebody's isolated audio. You get really good quality audio, and you have them just record, and then you load it into this AI, and now you can create ads. You've got copy that you can make,
mm-hmm.
with just typing it in and adjusting some parameters. It picks up on your speech patterns and stuff like that, and tries to mimic it the best they can. And as you put more info in it, because it is artificial intelligence, it's just going to get better.
Yeah, it's a learning machine. Like, it's
and so now you have somebody who can literally, I can do one movie. Or I can read for one movie, and now you've got my voice, and now you can just put me in all the animated movies and stuff like that and do the voice acting.
I mean, it's pretty nuts what it's going to do to the expenditures for movies, mm-hmm. and for music. And I showed you this Kanye West thing.
Right.
That sounded, it made this guy, he rapped a whole 8-bar verse.
Yeah.
And then put the AI Kanye on it.
He found a Kanye-esque beat, right? I don't think he made the beat. He just found a beat off of YouTube.
Same video.
Yeah, okay.
Kanye-esque beat.
Yeah, I sent it to the guys as soon as you showed me. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. It sound, even talking sounded like Kanye.
Yeah. It's crazy.
It was creepy.
I've seen people do use, because the Kanye one has become, I think that the guy that created that voice or learned and created the AI for that voice has given it out to people just kind of willy-nilly. And people were like putting it and dubbed over like different songs. And so I heard Day and Night, which is originally by Kid Cudi.
Yeah.
With they Kanye. Did it with Kanye. And then they did, I saw this video on TikTok where they're like, did you know that? That Day and, like, who was Day and Night done by? The guy's like, Kid Cudi. Like,
oh, no, it's Kanye
this
West.
This is the Mandela effect, because it was Kanye West.
Oh, yeah, he was talking about
it. And he was like, no way. And he plays it, and it's Kanye West. And he's like, no, I know it was Kid Cudi. He's like, freaking out, because he for sure was, you know, it was Kid Cudi.
But I could find their, you could go on YouTube, and you can find all these people's isolated tracks.
Yeah.
You could find their isolated vocals.
That's scary as shit.
And then you could just, dude, they have presidential speeches that are archived.
Yes, they do.
Scary. I can get all the presidential. We don't need Javier doing Kennedy anymore. We can get Kennedy.
It's me. I'm going to have sex with Marilyn Monroe. I'm kind of drunk. I'm doing a terrible voice.
On my first millions, they were talking about not just like the audio, the video, obviously the potential kind of stuff that we've been talking about. But he was talking about something about learning like an entire story. And from like a vector, I forgot what he called it, but it's like basically you're putting almost like a number, an identifier to this X thing, and you have this Y thing, and you're getting to compare exactly how far apart X is from Y, and they can be completely different things. You could have a movie and a soundtrack of a different movie and be like, how close could these be? And it's like you can literally, and they were talking about how this could be like a dating thing in the future. It's like you find all of these identifiers, all the things that people load about themselves, and the AI could take what has worked in the past for people and find legitimately a better
match.
Yeah, match for that person.
A better version
because
of
they're
match,
they're taking your entire life down to like ones and zeros and doing
what
the same
the
thing
fuck
with someone
are
else.
You doing over
it's
there?
Crazy. It's crazy.
Dude, speaking of Mandela effect, I'm going to ask you right now.
Okay.
In E.T.
Oh no.
What did he say out the window? He was like E.T.
Well, everyone says phone home, but that's not what he says.
What did he say?
I think he said phone home.
Hobby?
Phone.
Home. But that's what everybody
thinks. He says home phone.
Home phone.
Which makes no sense. E.T. home phone.
Home phone.
He doesn't say E.T. though, does he?
Yes.
Yeah.
He says E.T. home phone?
Because they taught him that they call him E.T. and so he's picking up on the, Yeah. I know.
Dude.
It's like the Berenstain Bears versus Bernstein or Bernstein.
Dude, Bernstein. Dude, it's crazy. Hey, where's your heart? Where's your heart?
It's on your... All
right, I know where my heart is.
Dude calls me and I was at the gym and he just goes, where's your heart?
Heart sits right in the center.
What the fuck? I was... Okay. Okay.
But I'm also in the medical field, so...
I sit center as well.
Right. So, where's the heart?
It is in the center, but you were taught as like kids.
You are taught as a kid that it's on the left side.
And they're also taught that your liver sits over, you know, in one spot.
Where are your kidneys?
But your kidneys are actually up.
They're up.
Right here.
Kidney punch is not, like when a boxer kidney punches you, it's not low back. I always thought low back.
Yeah.
Because that's what we were taught. Right. Supposedly, last year, here's some conspiracy for you in the audience. So last year, between May and September... Remember the CERN?
Super Collider, yeah.
Yeah, I was very freaked out by this.
Well, you should be. Because what the layman's terms of what that could do is that could pretty much fucking Marvel with Kang is literally what it could do with all the different timelines.
Yeah.
What it did was it supposedly exposed other dimensions and being able to pass through other dimensions. So supposedly, whenever they did that, was it in France? That where it was?
That's France? When they dug up the hole.
It's like 2 miles long. Like it's fucking insane.
Oh, shit.
Dude, it's a God particle or the particle accelerator. Yeah. So what it would that's what it did. So supposedly, here's the conspiracy of it. Last year, when that happened, it worked because it did work. What they were trying to do
they
worked.
They were looking for the God particle.
They were looking for the God particle and it worked. So what they're saying is that some people, that timelines, they fucked with stuff. So they were saying that some timelines got merged.
I believe in the multiverse theory. I do 100%. Believe in it.
Oh, I do too. I mean, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
But they were saying that because of that, there were things that were merged. So I've always been taught that the heart's on the left.
Right.
Always have since I was a little kid.
Yeah.
But they said that there are a couple of different timelines that are merged together right now because of that God particle accelerator, right? So, or that particle accelerator that found the God particle. So what they're saying is, if you say your heart's to, because I've talked to brilliant people that said the heart's to the left.
Yeah.
But are you calling us stupid?
No, no.
So I believe that the heart was on the left. I only recently found out that it's not truly on the left. It's actually in the center.
It is dead center behind the sternum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It sits behind the sternum.
But you just recently found that out.
Yeah. I've always been told it's like, it's not here. It's slightly to the left.
It's right
yeah,
here.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, yeah.
Like literally whenever I was in school learning.
I got told that because of the Pledge of Allegiance.
But it wasn't just that.
No. Whenever it was biology. It was books. It was graphs. It was bodies.
It was there. It was there. It was there. It was like right here. It was like right here.
It was right here.
When I was in school, I was taught to listen for heart tones like here, here, and here around the heart, not here.
Mm-hmm. Yes, dude. Mm-hmm. So what they're saying, I'm telling you, man, what they're saying was whenever that CERN, whenever CERN did their shit, that it merged a few timelines. That's why the things the ET.
Coming in from the chat, Kate's just saying we're just dumb.
Okay. Told you, babe, we're just dumb.
We're just dumb.
Listen, don't lump me in your circle, girl.
Hey.
Hey, she said it. Yeah. Not me. Listen, you're not dumb. You're brilliant, babe.
All right. Aww. So, Paul, we've been at this for a little bit.
Yeah, sorry.
Where can we find you? Where can anybody find you?
On the corner of Shamrock and Fox.
Social media.
Media. I'm close by.
You are. Yeah. You should come by. You could literally, like a block away.
Or you can find him at Asian Nights.
Oh, dude.
Haltman Beach.
Hey, listen, I will tell you that it's at NEXM Creative Media on Instagram. Don't even worry about the personal stuff. I filter everything through NEXM Creative because that's my baby.
Or Paul Andrew Style if you want to see Andrew sex appeal. And
Paul Andrew Style. I haven't posted there in a while. So just real quick before we go, the Paul Andrew Style thing was actually for me. That was because I was super overweight my entire childhood up until I was 25, right? So I have really bad body dysmorphia. Even to this day, horrible body dysmorphia. It's just what I have. Can't get rid of it. So I'm trying to fight it. So I did Paul Andrew Style because I was tired of my lack of confidence with things.
Mm-hmm.
And as you notice, I'm shirtless and even sometimes.
Yeah, you are.
Pantsless.
I'm well aware.
Paul Andrew Style on Instagram. but that was
Paul
literally.
Paul Andrew Style on OnlyFans.
That's right. Well, I wish. I'd make some money, man. Anybody can. Anyways, but I did that because it forced me to be in an uncomfortable spot. Which, in turn, when things are in an uncomfortable place, they evolve more.
Yeah.
And they have to adapt faster than they would if they were in a comfortable place just trying to move through life or the world evolving. So I forced myself to be in a super uncomfortable place, and I succeeded that goal of that. Yeah. So I haven't posted in a while because it was getting in the way of my business, and as soon as I stopped, my business started taking off again. And it's crazy because I was able to build that confidence that I was lacking, that was holding me back in business, and now that energy is being put towards business.
It's all connected.
It is. It is all connected. And so
would you call that Big Panther energy, baby?
You know what's funny is that I got a couple of those stickers right next to me.
Would you say that gave you some, because I think that you got some Big Panther energy from that.
I do.
All right.
But yeah, NEXM Creative Media, NEXM Creative, you can always come by. I welcome anybody in the doors at all times if you want to just get a little creative kick in the ass.
Love it there.
Like, it's so cool. I got PS5, Nintendo Switch, arcade with 18,000 plus games. Come by and see me. Literally, just come by. Be creative. Everyone should be creative.
I will say this. Like,
I drooled on myself in the middle of that sentence.
Ooh, it was cute.
It was like that. You like that? Right off my lips.
I do appreciate you, like, having your son involved in like, what you're doing. And, yeah. Like, he was over there with us at the Visit for Worth. And it was really cool to have him there.
That kid's funny.
It's just,
he's a cool kid, man.
He's just,
he is
like,
funny.
He was like at the event. He was just like, he was like a kid in a candy store.
Like, is this a rave for old people?
It's just like, he was like, great. What's that fish doing over there? Like,
shout out to B.
Salmon.
Yeah, shout out to my little Bebop. He's like 16 now. He's hating when I say that. But.
He goes to, no, we can't talk about where he goes.
Yeah,
to
let's
school.
Not.
Yeah,
Dolly,
that's weird.
Dolly drama.
All right.
No, but
thanks for hanging out with us on YouTube. Thank you all for joining us in the chat. If you haven't already done so, make sure you hit the subscribe button on YouTube. We got over 400 subscribers now, which yes. I know is not a lot, but that's
right.
Right.
We're getting there.
Thank
we're getting
you,
there.
Everyone, that's for hella subscribing. Good.
Also, I want to know who I can talk to about having a guest from OnlyFans here on the show that I would like to.
Shut the fuck up.
Whenever he's gone.
Shut the fuck up. So make sure you tell everybody, tell your friends, make sure they subscribe to us on YouTube. We'd really appreciate it. Help us out. You can find all of our stuff at The Funky Panther on all social medias, and then everything at thefunkypanther.com. Call us, text us, 817-677-0408. Oh, fuck. Stay good, y'all. I'm Chad.
Keep up with your mentals, y'all. I'm Javier.
And I'm Tim.
And we are
The Funky Panther!
Bye, Chad. See you never. Bye.
In my eyes, indisposed, in disguises no one knows. Hides the face, lies the snake. The sun is my disgrace. A boiling heat, summer stench. Neath the black, the sky looks dead. Call my name through the cream, and I'll hear you scream again. Black hole sun, won't you come and wash away the rain? Black hole sun, won't you come, won't you come? Stuttering, cold and damp, still the warm with tired friend. Times are gone for honest men, and sometimes far too long for snow.